and Ruffman Powell also flexing their muscle in a Warner Park Six Fest that set up a comfortable victory over the Patriots. There is no shortage of ammunition in the Guyana Amazon Warriors camp either. And Captain Shimron Hetmeyer and his men will want to get their campaign on the way with a bang.
So get up and unite for your team. We'll give the best we've got. It's how we
every
play.
Every band, every bat, every preach, every pond, every deal, every wicket, every stone. And the heart and soul and passion and the culture, Caribbean blows.
It's how we play.
We come out all nations. To the team in a unification. When the stadium ram beach at the grandstand, not the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.
Hero CPL action once again here at Warner Park in St. Kitts in this 2022 edition. Match number 4 features the Jamaica Tallawahs against the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Let's have a look at the arrivals powered by FedEx. Henrik Claassen and of course Shimron Hetmeyer leading the Warriors this year, hoping to take them one step further. Jandepaul Hemraj had a wonderful 100 here in St. Kitts last year, and they've got a lot more stars in tow for the Tallawahs. Ruffman Powell also hoping to have a better season with his power hitting unit. Here at Warner Park, we were supposed to have a toss a few minutes ago with a view to starting at 10:50 local time, but we've just had a small shower which seems to have abated as we speak. The pitch, as you can see, is covered. I think that will be removed quite shortly because the sun is starting to break through. The teams have been here at their usual arrival times, as we told you, and they've gone through their warm-up processes. We've had a lot of heavy rain yesterday, overnight, and early this morning, which caused a few damp spots around the square and the playing surface. But just towards the east of us, it looks quite good actually. And the covers are being removed as we speak. The match referee Rion King is out there. One or two officials supervising the procedures. And a really, really important match. Let's get an update on what conditions were like a bit earlier before this little sprinkle came in with our Republic Bank pitch check with Stacey Ann King.
There has been some rain yesterday into some overnight and early morning showers. So there would have been some difficulty for the ground staff to get work done. While sun is out now, the pitch was covered for a period of time, but ground staff have been tirelessly working. As I mentioned, the pitch has been covered, so therefore it means that there'll be a bit of moisture for the bowling team. It might just assist those bowlers to get a bit more out of their variations. Dimensions, well, to my left, shorter boundary, to my right, 66 meters. Therefore, the long boundary from the media end is going to be over 70. Well, those dimensions I mentioned, bowlers will have to try to restrict batters from targeting those short boundaries. Sun is out, good hard surface to play on, two good teams, we expect a good battle.
Thank you very much to Stacey Ann King. Hopefully that win will pick up a little bit stronger, and the threat already has dissipated of inclement weather, and the wind direction has changed a little bit today. Normally it's east-west, now it's going a little bit south-north. I don't know what that means. Great to have the pleasure of your company as per usual. Murali Kartik getting into his rhythm here. He's becoming a West Indian in every sense of the word. Lovely shirt as well. Murali, obviously we've had this delay. It's always disappointing for viewers, for players, with the Tallawahs playing the Amazon Warriors. How much are we, once we get a game, to look forward to this contest?
I'm looking forward to this contest because you want to see the Jamaican Tallawahs express themselves again against the spin of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. I think there's a spin treat on offer, some wonderful spinners, as I mentioned, against power hitting in a small ground, in a high scoring ground. Again, we're waiting if it's a full quota of 20 overs. Do we lose?
After an hour.
After an hour. So which is we're still in a perfect position. So I'm just hoping that it's a full game and we get some power hitting on view.
Yeah, Shemron Hetmeyer just walked behind Murali Kartik to get out there for the toss. So that's good news because the sun is starting to come out a little more in all its glory. This toss that is going to take place imminently, would it be advantageous to one person or the other, one team or the other?
We've generally seen a tendency to win the toss and bowl first. And I'm pretty sure that on a track like this, if there is dampness, it's going to stop and come. And if the sun bakes around, it just dries out after a bit. And then there'll be a bit of rolling as well. So I'm hoping that the team which wins the toss, or I feel that they'll bowl once again.
Experience and tactics with Ruffman Powell, much more experience, having captained the West Indies senior team, having led the Tallawahs for a couple of seasons versus a Shimron Hetmeyer. Under 19 World Cup champion and captain, obviously, but his first leadership of franchise cricket. How does that weigh up?
Look, franchise cricket and leading that is always a completely different kettle of fish because you're leading different players from different countries. Certain people are a lot more senior than you. Under 19, it's the same age group. Ruffman Powell, for the last 3 years, he's led a bit of West Indies cricket, although his win-loss record is actually lopsided towards the loss.
All right, we'll find out what will happen now, because thankfully we have sunshine, we have a break in inclement weather, and just over my left shoulder, just behind me somewhere, is Danny Morrison ready for the toss.
Rightio, we're all in readiness. Finally, the weather's just dissipated a bit. Got the old fun 88 coin toss with Rion King, the match referee, and we've got hitters and robbers. Shimron Hetmeyer and Ruffman Powell. You've got the coin, haven't you? Thank you, Robbers.
It's gone and it's a tail.
So,
Ruffman has won the toss.
Ruffman, you've won it and are going to...
Oh, we're going to bowl first.
You're going to bowl first. Conditions, that overhead, the rain around, is it?
Yeah. You know, it's a lot of rain around. Yesterday it also rained a lot, you know, so the pitch have a little bit of moisture. Let's see if we can utilize that moisture early.
You guys won that first game quite nicely. Confidence going into season 10?
Yeah, I think the guy is playing good cricket. You know, we talk about starting well as a team, and I think we did that the last game. You know, today provides another opportunity for us to do that as a team, so the guys are chomping at the bit and ready to go.
Shimron, you're going to bat first. Young captain, do you feel a little bit of that weight on your shoulders with your other senior players?
Not yet. I'm hoping that it doesn't come in afterwards, but so far it's been all right.
Very exciting in terms of the finals being played in Guyana this season 10. Five finals, you guys. Are you going to make it this year? This is your year, hitters?
I think so, too. I think we've been waiting a long time for the finals to actually be in Guyana, so we're up and ready for that.
Any changes from your side from the first one?
No, we played the same 11.
Same. And for you guys, some nice stars in your side. You got a balance of spin and pace. You happy?
Yeah, we're quite happy with how we are now.
Oh, good one. All right, gents, go well. Good to see you. Rightio. JTs, they won it, and they're going to go up front and have a bowl.
Thank you very much to Danny Morrison and, of course, the captains and that Jamaica Tallawahs team, Murali Kartik. Same team.
Yeah, it's unchanged and rightly so. Why would you want to change something which has done well? They racked up a big score and they've got, as I said, a good enough bowling attack. Lots of variety, two spinners in Imad Wasim, Chris Green, but Mohammad Amir, Miguel Pretorius, and my favorite, Nicholson Gordon. He's there. I'm happy.
All right, and for the Amazon Warriors, of course, Gudakesh Moti. No Pramal in that lineup, but they've got Romario Shepherd, they've got Ludeen Smith, the power hitters, Heinrich Klaassen in there, as well as Paul Sterling, the Irishman. So with Tabrez Shamsi, that really does send a message as to how strong that spin ammunition will be for the Amazon Warriors. So the captains and the coaches have selected their teams, and now you can log on to the Dream 11 app and you can have your say. Choose your team and let's see how it matches up at the end of this game. Right, so Murali Kartik, you said it will probably be the captain winning, choosing to field. How difficult is it for a team to identify what a good total is batting first, given that it may dry off by the time they come into the field?
Yeah, and that's where lies the problem, isn't it? If there is a bit of dampness, which you hope there will be, because there's been a bit of, as you said, weather yesterday and this morning. It is dry, but it's not completely dry, and then it will dry out. So what happens is that the team coming in, you have a feel of the first few overs, then you know that by the time the other team comes into bat, this would have dried out a lot more. So therein lies that tricky situation. But I'm hoping that maybe if the openers get in, we've seen that there are some of them who can get a big score, and if they get to maybe 150, 160, then you can unleash the spin twins. I would hope that at least 150, 160 is something. They reach par score, which is 165 here at Warner Park.
Well, the good news is they've got their full quarter of overs to do it at the moment, providing there's no more inclement weather. And the man responsible for determining much of the tactics of the Amazon Warriors, he's an under-19 West Indies World Cup winning captain, and he has a great deal of ambition for this Warriors this season. Let's hear him a bit more from that young player.
I've gotten the opportunity now to captain my side and captain my country as well. It's something that I can't wait to actually go out on the field and start doing. Being here for a while, yes, I think I am ready. It's something that I've been looking forward to for the past couple of years. The strength of our squad, it's youth, I would say. I just think it's really nice to have the guys that have played before. It's like a whole group of different guys, and then we have some experienced guys as well that has been playing cricket for a while now as well. It's all about us coming together as one and trying to learn from each other, and it's just to go out and do our best as a team.
Warriors fight to the end! Warriors fight to the end! 1, 2, 3, Warriors!
My favorite moments of this tournament was, I think, getting 100. That was one moment that I could relive every day. It was just me just executing and just basically hitting the ball. That was something that I really enjoyed doing. And to cap it all off, we won as well.
A century for the 21-year-old Shimron Hetmyer.
Well, we've always had a good chance.
And the Warriors, they go in despair.
I just think it's for us to cross the line this year, and it really helps us so much more to have the semi-finals and the finals being in our hometown. That's something that all Guyanese players, fans, everyone has been looking forward to, and more so myself, because I literally cannot wait to go back to Guyana and play some cricket, because it's been a while. Having a crowd there, it means a lot to me. It's nice to have some sort of support there when you're playing. It feels normal when you have some support. When there wasn't any support, it didn't feel the same. Like, you didn't have the same energy playing and going out doing your stuff and so on. So now that the crowds are back and that we'll be traveling just a little bit more than we did last year, it'll be really nice to just look up in the stands and you see some of your family members and stuff there in the stands cheering you on and stuff.
Shimron Hetmyer, every little playful young guy, but having matured and is still maturing. And of course, tactically, we know the captains are responsible largely, but his work with the bat, Hetmyer, that is, how significant is that going to be to this team and his leadership?
Yeah, he's the skipper of the side, so obviously there is that added pressure, that added responsibility, and also from the view that he's an international now. Bishi's been around the West Indies team for a while. As you mentioned earlier, he's been to the IPL, he's playing other franchise cricket, and he would have seen that word travels fast. When you are a power hitter, everybody's trying to curb your instincts, curb your shot play, and he would have to improve certain aspects of his shot making, which have to be beyond the onside. So there has to be something on the offside. So those are things which will come into play, especially in a tournament like this.
All right, Murali Kartik has chosen his three Dream 11 players to look out for. Is Shimron in there?
No, he's not in there. He's not in there. Look, I've got my favourite, Nicholson Gordon, there, firstly. And then Heinrich Klaassen, I feel, is going to be a key figure in this Amazon Warriors lineup because he's a power hitter. He can also maneuver the singles. He plays spin really well. I thought I picked someone else too. Who was it?
Brandon King.
Brandon King. I picked Brandon King. Who's picked Shimron Hetmyer in my place? I picked Brandon King.
Total confusion here. Carter doesn't know who he's picked.
I picked Brandon King. That's why I was surprised to see Shimron Hetmyer over there.
All right, that might be a portent of things to come. The crowds have already gathered here at Warner Park. Thank you very much, Murali. We'll hear more from Murali in a little while. We've had a break. Because of the inclement weather yesterday, overnight and early this morning. But the ground staff have worked hard and they've gotten things in order. Hopefully no more rain. We should have a full contest if that happens after the short break. Live action.
Hello and welcome into a beautiful scene as ever here at St Kitts and Nevis for the Hero CPL in the 10th edition. Tallawahs are going to lock horns with the Amazon Warriors here at Warner Park at St Kitts. And some of us, on a day off yesterday, I can tell you, went across to Nevis for the first time ever. And it really is a treat to behold, even if there's a little bit of rain around, and there has been here, so the cover's on and off quite frequently, and a delayed start. This is what they're playing for, the Hero CPL trophy in all its glory, rather tall trophy, all on it, great stuff. Paul Sterling, he's here, he's come out from the UK and he'll be sweating profusely because of the humidity factor that's massive with all the rain that was around yesterday and overnight. So the players just getting ready, the umpires taking the ball from the plinth. Dayton Butler and Verdane Smith are out in the centre. Kiss of it, yeah. I remember that well. Hopefully it'll swing a lot. Nigel Duguid is our television umpire upstairs, the third ump. And the match referee, Rion King, who was out at the toss there for just a little bit a while ago and came down the side for Jamaica. Rodman said, yeah, look, we're going to go as a group. There's been that rain around. Hopefully, is there a bit of moisture? May just get a little bit of swing. Very heavy, humid conditions out there. Sun is out. It's gorgeous, but I think for the players' comfort level, Paul Sterling's going to feel it, no doubt. I know the UK's been having a sterling summer there in the United Kingdom, but here, with the humidity factor and the beautiful Leeward Islands, and that overnight rain, very sticky indeed. So, Sterlo, I don't know. He's going to be out in the centre there, Paul Sterling. Looking forward to seeing him get going. Yeah, and Chandrapal Hemraj is the lefty going to go out. So these two stocky fellows, one stockier than the other, out there, and early Carter alongside. Both sides have got their good complement of spin, haven't they? Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir, and good morning to everyone. Yeah, you're absolutely right. It's very sticky. I worked up a sweat by the time I came from below to the comm box. It's not going to be easy for everyone. Look, we've been here for a while. It has been warm, but not as sticky, Danny. And coming to the point you made, nice complement of spinners, both sides, but very different. Chris Green and Imad Wasim, finger spinners, and they actually don't try and spin the ball that much. Whereas when you talk about the Amazon Warriors, one of the best T20 bowlers in world cricket, Tabrez Shamsi, Imran Tahir, vastly experienced and skillful, and then the young Gudakesh Moti. So very different. Chandrapal Hemraj, a nice strike rate, best of 105.
Yeah, he and Sterling, they do like to play their shots. After all, T20 in the power play. Countdown is on, so we're not far away. There's a little bit of sawdust in terms of the run-up here from our broadcasting end at Warner Park. So we're ready to rock and roll here.
All right, gentlemen, let's play.
Let's play. Let's get on with it. Yes. Fans coming in. It is Saturday morning after all here, local time. And well, we're pretty much almost an hour late. Almost. 55 minutes late. And we're going to have Muhammad Amir. The first one. Up against Paul Sterling. The slipper's in. That's the skipper himself with Rodman Paul. Good carry. Good to see.
In these conditions, you would hope that there is a little bit of swing on offer for someone who's very good with the new ball, Mohammad Amir. We saw some swing the other night for him in the first game that he played, but he bowled from the media end.
Full. Think about two, but won't, because it's in that little small pocket. We're right pretty much in the middle. You've got four strips here at Warner, and the two strips in the center, pretty much the middle. In fact, one over would be probably the bang on middle strip of the square, given that there's only four. It used to be five. I'm sure there was five. You're busy. Yeah, they're liking this, the weather. Finally getting out and playing. Mentioned the sawdust there. It's just behind Chandrapal Hemraj. He's going to take strike now. So the left-hander. That'll be a little disconcerting for the keeper. It's Jungu standing out just there. Now we're going to have another little extra slip in. And the guy's sort of backward at gullies on the fence. Like a deep gully right on the edge. We've sort of got like a fourth slip. He's still directing traffic here, so Amir's had to go back and load up again. But yeah, it's a staggered slip for me. You could say it's either a fine gully, or would you go with that guy behind point? It's almost like a deep gully. Ball slip and a first slip. Oh, nice.
And a swoosh and a miss. Yeah, just to finish on, you touched upon the spinners and the reason why I'm bringing them here, although Mohammad Amir is bowling, it's a bit of swing and bounce, is because very different spinners. You're looking forward to the power hitting of the Tallawahs against the spin of the Amazon Warriors. The Amazon Warriors, much quicker spinners in the air. Chris Green does turn the odd ball, but much quicker, much taller. Whereas wrist spin of Tabrez Shamsi, both South Africans. It'll be interesting. Hemraj off the mark.
Baby Nellan, quick as ever. Hog and old paint being used. Ground staff. Geez, they've been busy. Oh, they've been busy over the last couple of days, given the weather on Friday, which is a day off for everyone. Very brown as ever, but there's certainly that moisture content, understandably so. Timing. You've got to watch out for Mohammad Amir. It's a lovely, just a little hint of shape. Not a lot used to, of course. The balls are different, I reckon, in the last sort of 5 to 8 years. But that shape of the ball and then a little bit of difference in pace. See, right smack in the middle of the pitch there, you can see it just appreciably darker, just a little bit. Whether that's that part of that, used to be a lot more grassy, a lot more thatch there. It's all been shaven away now. But it has held that moisture, I reckon, a bit more in the middle of the square here. So that's probably a part of the reason the ground stump and the run-ups and everything for the umpires to say, look, we need to wait. Up in the air. Hasn't got all of it. Sterling has got an early trip to the dressing room. Kenar Lewis holds on to this very easy one to have an El Dorado celebration for the Tallawahs early.
Yeah, I was just about to say that Paul Sterling has been watchful and understandably looking out for that swing. But then a couple of steps, shortening the length there, Mohammad Amir was not in a position to play any sort of a shot, especially not an attacking one and a powerful one. Paul Sterling goes for one. The Warriors are 2 for 1.
One down early for the Warriors. And here's Shea Hope. Classy at the test level. We can all appreciate that, his record. And here, not bad, 116. I know he'd like to get that up a bit. But, it's mainly in terms of white ball cricket with 50 overs. Here he is trying to, you know, extend the string to the bow, as it were. He's going to be up against Chris Green, who's played a lot of this format. Specialises it, of course. So we've got Shea Hope to join Hemraj out in the centre now. Oh, it was a lovely bit of curve. A smile on the dial from Kartik next door.
Hey, hello. You got more swing than Mohammad Amir as a spinner. But that's the wicket. Paul Sterling trying to hit it over mid-off. But he was on the move while he was playing that shot.
Oh,
yeah. The odd bit which he gets to turn. He's when you look at him, I'm talking about Chris Green. He's a tall man. But this was the catch. Kenar Lewis taking it comfortably. Big unit himself.
Bounce. That was appreciable. Just that last one. First one with a swing with the arm ball. And then that bit of bounce and a little bit of grit. Exciting. Oh, there we go. There we go. It's called a wide, but I tell you what, Chris Green won't mind that.
That's the dampness you're talking about, isn't it? That's the dampness where the spinners can actually exploit it. Tall man hits it into the surface. He's surprised himself.
Beautiful shape, isn't it? It's such a great little curvy arm ball. And the breeze, so it's over his left shoulder, so it's sensational.
It's interesting how he sets himself up. Every delivery is the same. He's at the top of the mark. That's the two-fingered arm ball or the curve ball. Pulled away should be one. He sets himself up. Bit of a deep breath. The shrug of the shoulders. Has a look at the batter. A pause before he starts. And off he goes.
So he sets himself. It's a bit like a rugby player taking a penalty kick in rugby. So it goes through that whole breathing routine, set up, and then line things up, and then into it. Difference now because of Hemraj, the left-hander, on, and we're going to have Chris Green coming around. Green and Rovman just chatting about fields and at each other. Rovman's at slip, just conducting traffic. He wants man that boundary to come off slightly. Good wicket, quite straight. Oh, good luck, chaps.
Oh, all spinners are lining up to bowl now. Middle of the stump, turns close to the tram line.
Beauty. So he's going to hold on to the strike here is Chandival Hemraj. Only three from the second. It's 5 for 1.
Oh,
Well, a hero fan of the match candidate for sure. Come in your colours, show your creativity and your passion, and you can possibly win 500 US. There's another one. Oh, the Amazon Warriors, hell of a hat. Oh, and a hell of a delivery here from Amir. It's just that lovely little length there. Well, you're excited. We mentioned the two last names there, Tahir and Shamsi. Outstanding. And of course, Moti as well. So you get the three spinners, the engine room of the spinners there. And then you get the pace boys, Shepherd and Kimo Paul and Odin Smith. So you got the spinners all together hiding out. And the paces there. Nice. Oh, big neck. Beautiful bit of movement. And there is that extra little bit of movement. And just enough off the blade. Second one down now. Another Republic Bank classic by the keeper here in season 10.
Yeah, the Tallawahs are all over Amazon Warriors at the moment. Uncomfortable stay in the middle. But Chandapal Hemraj couldn't get to grips with the spin. Mohammad Ahmed troubled him. A bit of a play and a miss, but this time a play and a nick. But Chandapal Hemraj, he too goes for two. It's 5-2.
Here's the captain, a youngster. Sharon Hetmeyer's now assumed that role and he's embracing it. He's excited about it and really wants to do a good job with it. And then he's also got aspirations. And a wonderful interview we had earlier. Quite like to one day captain this country, the West Indies. So let's see how he goes here. He's going to be under the pump, no doubt, because toss went the way of Rothman Powell. They're going to go front and go as a group, utilize this moisture. As I say, we're just under an hour starting later than usual. So instead of 10 a.m., it was 10:55. And the humidity around and a nice bit of cloud cover certainly helping spin and swing. Mohammad Amir is enjoying himself with 2-for-2 from 1.2. Beautifully played. Solid and in behind it. Great start.
He was looking onside. That was the surprising thing. You saw what he was trying to do was slightly short. Yes, understandable. But then it just left him. Extra bit of bounce. The bat closed. Getting the top edge. And a fine one straight to the wicketkeeper, Amir Jangu.
Mohammad Amir in CPL, power plays, he's taken 13 wickets at an average of 7.5. Outside the power play, only one wicket, an average of 77. So hence, often is the case, he goes up front and bowls three. So that 93% of his wickets in the power play, so no surprises that he often does bowl three up front and just save him for one back at the death end, the back end of the innings. And he's got 2-for-2, so don't be surprised if he gets another one after this. So solid. Look at the difference with someone who's really comfortable about their game and he's just wanting to make an effort. Yeah, $500. And look out. Going to be keen today, Saturday and Sunday. 10th anniversary. The happy birthday to the Hero CPL. And some of us have been very blessed to come to them all. It's the biggest party in sport. Oh, you better believe it. We are going to go crazy again tomorrow as well. And a gap. Nice. Little dab. The underway. So you won't mind that. Shimron Etmeyer. He'll keep the strike and get off the mark. Good over though. 6-for-2. two openers gone. It was a little too hot in the kitchen for Sterling and Himraj. Both openers falling to Muhammad Amir early on, and there's certainly a little bit of swing for both bowlers. Certainly that arm ball for Chris Green and some purchase, a big turn. Angostura, chill moment, yes. Hang out, just take it easy. The Broly is warm. Angostura refreshing chill moment. Outstanding. It is a cold one. While you're down there, GB. This is going to be a fascinating little contest now. Green up against his old team. Teammates from the Warriors.
Also conditions going for him. 6'2". There's a bit of moisture. He's getting appreciable turn from the surface. A left-hander in front of him. So everything loaded in his favour at the moment.
Is that when he played it, missed it. The length there, it's just enough shape. And then a Bert Fuller, just a little. And a miss. Swung back in again. Yeah, as you say, Card, is trying to get to the onside. Strange. Given it was so far outside off.
Boy,
oh, it's a beauty. That's the pace. And look at the bounce. And it's just held enough on the surface.
He mixed it up nicely. That's where the skillful spin bowling comes in. Nice action, body behind it. He knows that he will get bounced from the surface. And also that moisture allowing that turn, that stop and turn.
Faster little arm ball. Beautiful, yeah. Yeah, Carter's, you're loving this. I'm loving it too. Great strategy being set up here and what he's trying to do. Chris Green, that is, against Hetmeyer.
Don't think he's picking him. He's not picking that two-fingered arm ball which is swinging in. He's only seeing the length and trying to cut. And that's something which happens with many batters from this part of the world. They look at length rather than what the bowler's doing or bowler, how he's released the ball. Watchful this time.
And that power play slipping away. This is just about the end of the fourth, and Guyana's lowest power play. CPL's 13 runs. That was against these guys in Guyana, against the JTs in 2016. Get back, Skip. So there's a maiden, a ripper from Chris Green. It is still 6-2. Champions from back in 2016. That's how long ago it is since the Jamaica Tallawahs have won the Hero CPL. Very good looking side, though. Very well been good looking. Yeah, as I say, very well to be good looking on paper. You've got to perform as a group physically out in the middle. Can they do it? Can they lift the trophy for the first time since 2016? Dances, the masquerade ones, that is. Looking forward to more celebrations today. Guyana flags, Jamaican flags, Kitts and Nevis. Victoria starts with a good Yorker. Oh! Is that Fabian Allen again? Man, is Eddie everywhere. You're going about good length pace bowling. Nothing wrong with a quick bowler getting a Yorker in early. And Pretorius, who's renowned for them, any stage of an innings. Wonderful delivery. And Hetmeyer wanted to rotate the strike. But I tell you what, you've got to keep an eye on Fabian Allen and co. In those hot zones, point just behind. Skipper striking. Thinking of two. Yeah. Nice. It was just a little bunt into the onside. And Ken R. Lewis, well, he's not nearly as quick, is he?
Yeah, a couple of close infielders, which means that there are vacant spots on the onside. There's only mid-on, a shot fine, and a deep square. Although the bowler wanted the man to be moved over to mid-wicket, Robin Powell saying that he wants this field to continue.
Because of that, that's exactly why Murali Carter, you're spot on. Because it's doing enough for them. It's just gripping a little. You don't have to get it to swing much. Just enough, and you bowl that lovely corridor, you're going to get good players out. This is an absolute peach.
And this is one aspect of Robin Powell's captaincy, which I think Ian Bishop spoke about, and also something which I've noticed right through even the Sky X60, and now that he's quite forthright and firm in the kind of decisions he wants to make. He's slightly ahead of decision making rather than following the ball, which can happen with many captains, especially in this format. So he wants to stamp his authority, play in a dominant way, and that is quite visible. Now a couple of slips. The fourth slip comes into a tight second slip.
Hansen, very handsome, just a little bit overpitched from Pretorius on this occasion, and it gets the trick.
Yeah, against the run of play this morning, it's been dominated by the ball, and then a beautiful shot.
Really was classical. Well, if you want to talk about that, you better download that CPL 60 chat app. Get onto it, download it, and you can chat to a few of us. Have your view, have your say. It's nicely played again. Good, sensible cricket this from the skipper, who's relishing the opportunity to take the captaincy and get into things, get into proceedings in this 10th edition of Hero CPL. We're back to the right-hander and Shea Hope, who's been a little bit of a spectator at times, just in this opening stanza of almost the power play. One to go in the fifth, and then one more over the power play. And Hope hasn't had much of the strike of late. Powell still at slip. No! Played well bowled, and a good field set. So we've had five, and the Warriors are chugging along at 14 for two.
Nice Saturday morning for the young ones. Celebrate here at Hero CPL, watching the Amazon Warriors and the Tallawahs. Shimon Hetmeyer leading the Amazon Warriors for the first time. I'm fascinated. If you've just joined us, we had a lot of rain yesterday, overnight and early this morning, and the game was delayed by about an hour because of dampness in the pitch and the outfield, and you see the ball deviating off the surface. Like that. No loss of overs, and that's a good thing. So it leads me, Stacey Ann King, to wonder what really can you aim for batting first, because if the sun beats down, the nature of the surface may change later.
Good morning, Ian Bishop. Good morning, everyone, wherever you're logged on.
Oh, yes, boys, yes, boys.
Yeah, Guyana Amazon Warriors 14 for 2. Three balls shy of this first power play. I think the issue for them would be that they've lost two quality batters. They now need to rebuild. Yeah, they've got Hope and Hetmeyer. They've lost Paul Sterling, Chandra Paul Hemraj. So rebuilding phase for them. They've got power to the back, but these two need to just stay a bit longer. Hopefully the pitch dries off as well.
Mario Shepherd had it up.
Oh, damn!
First run of Chris Green for 11 deliveries. Again, it's how well they, you talk about Romario Shepherd, Kimo Paul, Ubane Smith, Budakesh Moti can all strike the ball. How do you set it up for them? That power hitting lower order, Heinrich Klaassen, down to come next. But you've got to set it up for these power hitters.
Yeah, therefore this partnership would mean a lot in the context of this game.
This has been Chris Green at his best. The power play is complete, 15 for 2.
Has been Ghana Amazon Warriors' second lowest power play. A hero bike. Sponsors of the hero CPL.
Very good. Extremely athletic. From Chris Green, he brings all of that, doesn't he, Stacey Ann? He brings that prowess with the ball. He can strike the ball with willow in hand, but he's also a very safe pair of hands in the field.
Yeah, good attributes to have.
Thing about Chris Green, you know, is that his off spinner is bowled with a different seam position, obviously, with the arm ball. And I sometimes wonder if, as a batter, top class batter, I'm talking about, not guys like plebs like me who batted down the lower end, whether you can actually pick up that seam position coming towards you with the arm ball. Remember facing a guy called Winston Reed, who now looks after the ground in Barbados, and for one little period I could pick up the arm ball. Let's have a look at the contrast. Off spinner with that seam spinning obviously from leg to off, and look at the seam position with the arm ball.
You can just see more use of the finger in the arm ball.
I wonder if the really high-class batters who look at the ball out of the hand can pick it up. And I know I'm talking slow motion, but I'm also talking from practical experience. How challenging. I'd love to hear from some of the batters watching by television.
Also, just look at the seam off spin ball. This seam is a bit more scrambled, but the arm ball, it's much straighter.
Bolts it quickly, it's harder to pick up, obviously. Andrew glanced at the umpire to see whether he called it wide or not. One for the over. Thank you. couldn't cut it near anywhere near backward point. Fabian Allen is lurking there. Another good over, three off it, 118 for two.
Watch the CPL on the Sportsmax app. Download it, and it's free in the Caribbean, so get on it.
It's Warrior Nation. We'll all be queued in. They perhaps have the largest following. I mean, I haven't counted it, but man, on social media, they're at you.
Downloaded the CPL 60 chat myself and been having a chat with some of the fans, especially with this game on today. It's very interactive. You should get on it, Bish.
I'm not doing that. I had a few strong opinions over the years from the five-time finalists, the Amazon Warriors fans. I think they've done quite well, actually, to get to five finals out of nine seasons. I think some people look at that as a negative. Outside the line, perhaps struck outside the line, that'll be the question. And Rothman Powell says no. Sorry, I was thrown off a little bit by the guy standing in the background on the grass banks there. Could be a candidate for the hero fan of the match. That is very, very good. I wonder where his parents are. They let him come to the ground all alone, baby.
Plenty at him, Chris.
I know it's very slow, and that's, I'm curious to see how they set this up. I wonder if Fabian Allen, who hasn't bowled, he didn't bowl in the sky at 60 from my recollection, didn't bowl in the first game. In fact, analysts told us he bowled one over in the 60. So I wonder if he could come into play today with ball. Not saying he will, I'm just saying it's a possibility because the ball is gripping on the surface.
Come on, Greeny.
It has been a spinner's paradise, even though Mohamed Amer has picked up the two wickets.
Good stop again. So the ball is gripping in the surface, and Shehu dips his head. A little bit in annoyance, I suppose, is the word I'm looking for, that it isn't coming on as he would like.
How is that?
19 for two, one off the over, and Chris Greene, five runs off his four overs. Remarkable.
Chris Green has been exceptional with his off breaks. 20 dot balls in his four overs, just 5 runs conceded. And we rate 1.25.
Shocked to know it's not his best figure, Stacey. He actually went for 3 runs off his 4 overs at the Brian Lara Stadium, your part of the world, makes sense, against Barbados, 2020. Dinesh Kartik is standing at attention next door in our green room. I'm sorry, Murali Kartik. He wish he was Dinesh. Wish he could bat like Dinesh. Because Nicholson Gordon is into the attack. Gordon and the way that he's come through the system, the under 14 and age group cricket in Jamaica, under 19 World Cup back in 2010, nicknamed Stunner. Acknowledgement of his dad's name, and it has just stuck with him from the New Hope Primary School. School that Jermaine Blackwood also attended back in Jamaica. St. Elizabeth Technical High School, and who's originated from Westmoreland. Good first class season these past months.
And he made his debut, CPL debut, in that first game against Patriots. Picked up 3 for 32.
A reflection on the 3 wickets that he picked up. Andre Fletcher across the line. Dwayne Bravo. Then Shiffin Rutherford. 3 important and pedigreed batters. At least a couple of runs. It's a strong bowling action. As I said, he's 30 years old, so call him a youngster. Remember the first over he bowled in the Sky X60, the left shoulder, the head fell away significantly, and he bowled, dragged a couple of wides. But it is an energetic and vibrant action. Still does open up and fall away just a little bit. But the coaches that have worked with him say he's remarkably fit. Coley, who you know well, who is in the opposition camp, talks about his commitment to the game and how seriously he takes his fitness and his enthusiasm. A real team man is the way that he described.
Yeah, you can tell.
Thing of beauty, and we have to crown it a fun 88 magic moment off the bat of Shea Hope. 29 for 2 though.
10 runs coming off that over, the most expensive of the innings thus far. Partnership moves on to 24 from 41. So again, good time to start advancing things.
a classical Shehoop drive. And he'll be hoping that the ability and opportunity to play that, he'll be hoping it means the ball is coming on a little bit better for the next few overs, because they really need to start some sort of acceleration with 8 wickets left. Fun 88 magic moment. Visit CPL social media to see the winning moment. I'll be logging on to that, Stacey Ann King, to see that. I'm not promising any interaction, but I'll be logging on to the app. And here's your guy, Imad Wasim. 2 wickets in the first match. Usually bowls a really good arm ball, but can also bowl that one that goes from off the leg to the left-hander. Yep.
This partnership, 25 of 42. Hope on Hetmeyer. Almost 10 overs, almost the halfway stage. They need to get going.
Big side of the ground. Can they press for 2? Yes. And these two, I've seen them in times past playing for the West Indies. They've had the odd miscommunication, but they generally run well with each other.
Yeah, you saw Hetmeyer took off and you knew it was 2. Good running, good communication.
Just saw the flags here, and I heard Marili Kartik saying Mohammed Amir started at our media center in today, but in the first game, but then moved to the Lozak Road end today, and it's because the wind switched around while we were out there. It was almost going south-north as opposed to east-west. You see that? That is usually going from right of screen to left. It's coming almost from the bottom of the screen to the top. Quite unusual here. So you're hitting with the wind if you're Shehoop down the ground here and against it from the other end. Anyway, Stacey and I will be back maybe later in the day sometime, but for now, it's the Angostura chill.
Hello everyone, welcome back. Match number four in the Hero CPL. 35 for two at the minute. Sterling and Hemrat out cheaply. Pope and Hetmeyer at the crease for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Jamaica Tallawahs, well, they've been outstanding. A couple of wickets for Mohamed Amir and Chris Green. Look at that economy. Omega XL Skycam taking off. Really extraordinary, wonderful aerial shots, adding depth and perspective to our broadcast. Just beautiful here in St. Kitts, and particularly this ground, Warner Park, giving us the bird's eye view. Isn't it stunning? Here in St. Kitts and Nevis, Danny? Yeah, St. Kitts and Nevis, such a wonderful twin island republic. Beautiful tourist destination, no matter what your tastes. So many beach activities, but of course they've got the mountains too. You can take a hike, you can head over to Nevis, get stung by some bumblebees. Danny, I believe you did that.
Oh, killer bees.
Yeah, Nevis loved it. Absolutely loved it. All the years of coming here, hadn't quite been to Nevis. And so, St. Kitts, loving you. Follow your heart.
Yeah, well, let's just follow Gautam Bimani. I think he's ready for us.
Yes, I was also mesmerized by the shots of St. Kitts and Nevis, but not a pretty sight here at the Republic Bank fan stand. If you are a Guyana Amazon Warriors fan, I've got Omar with me. Yes, there's a bit of moisture around, little tough for the batters. How do they dig themselves out of this hole? 35 for 2 and 10.
Yeah, I guess the guys go there for put their best effort to get this, but I guess because of the weather we have here in St. Kitts, but that's the first game for us. I mean, we still got this, yeah? We still have it. And we looking forward for the better games in Guyana as well.
We're looking forward to going to Guyana as well. But I love your confidence. Tell me, yeah. Guyana always there, almost there. They reach finals. What do they have to do different this year if they reach a final to lift that trophy?
We have to push our best performance out there with the guys them, and hopefully we go to get this victory.
Maybe they've got to make some noise like we make here at the Republic Bank fan stand. What do you say, guys?
Yeah! Yeah.
Yeah! 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 Gautam Bimani, we already know the Guyana Amazon Warriors fans are full of heart. They've had to withstand a lot over the years. Oh, that will do a bit for them in the fan stand. A hero maximum for Shimron Hetmeyer.
First maximum of the innings for the Warriors. They've been well and truly under the pump here from the JTs. And he got one in his arc, got one in his slot. Shimron Hetmeyer to go with his boundary. Really has been tough going. This is the trick, and I think the champ in the fan stand was also trying to get across, can his Warriors flick the switch and actually get something a little bit more competitive in the last sort of 7 to 8 overs here of this innings?
Yeah, well, Shimron Hetmeyer certainly thinks so. Beautiful into the offside this time. It's 4 more for the Warriors.
Season 10, new skipper, some new players at the franchise of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. And the captain at the moment is well and truly front and center. Shimmy across. The hitters through cover. Yes. Lovely. Could be a Rario moment. Jump of those NFTs. Collectibles.
Ooh, and soft hands too. Yeah, wonderful moment for Shimron Hetmeyer right now. Captaining the Guyana Amazon Warriors for the first time. And he's had a job to do already this morning. It was a good toss to win, as the Jamaica Tallawahs did, sent them in. Of course, some rain overnight. And he's been standing up after the loss of two early wickets in his team.
Yeah, it was a good toss to win, no doubt. Given what we've seen of the overhead conditions playing a part with a more of a moist pitch. Yeah, hard work, as you say, Alex Jordan, but not impossible, particularly now if the captain, Shimon Hetmeyer, can stay there and be there for the remaining sort of, just over nine overs. Can he be there for the bulk of it and have the lion's share of the strike?
Couple of spinners, they've got their own, Tavray Shamsi and Imran Tahir. Yeah, it's a wonderful opportunity for Shimron Hetmeyer. He's faced 35 balls, got 31 for his troubles. So 14 off the over after 11, the Warriors 49 for 2. Yep, the last over, the best so far for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. The sun is out, things are looking up.
Okay, Imad. Come on, boys. Good to see you, boys.
Imad Wazim continuing his spell from the media center end.
Oh, back up.
Biggie, quick, please. Hetmeyer, one of the best players of spin in our region. Don't be worried by that. That's the 50 up for the Warriors. An appreciation shown around the ground by their diehard fans, fantastic fans, who have been rewarded this year. They'll have the finals in Guyana.
Yeah, I had to ask him that at the coin toss. So given that you've got the finals, finally, in your own backyard, is it your year? It is. Over the line, five finals the Warriors have been in. Incredible. 9 years. Is the 10th birthday celebrations. Could they do it?
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, it can be argued that the Guyana has some of the most ardent cricket fans in the region, for sure. Guyana, of course, physically a part of South America, but the only country in South America to have been a British colony, so very much a part of the Caribbean community. Breadbasket, the very heartbeat, in fact, of our region, and wonderful. Wonderful cricket fans, knowledgeable and passionate. Yeah, they got to get moving here. Went fine, shouldn't get there. Just pick up a couple of runs for that. It's an interesting one, Danny, because we know the Jamaica Tallawahs have some big hitters. They've put big runs on the board already for this year. So what would be the number in the mind of the Warriors at this stage?
It's tough. It's tough given what's going on the surface, and you lose two up front, you lose your openers who really are strikers.
Yeah.
So at the moment, you're only going at, so let's call it 4.6. And then, you know, you think of projected scores, let's say you've got to get 10, so you've got to get close to 140, it just has to be. And you're just never quite sure then, because of the pitch, I know it's drying out, but it'll still go, no doubt, for... the spin legends, Shamsi, a little bit of Imran Tahir. Oh, yeah, just got to see if he can get to that 140.
Yeah, well, they'll need their spin legends. Jamaica Tallawahs, well, they've got the second highest total ever in CPL. Oh, there's Curtly Ambrose, the assistant coach of the Tallawahs, looking serious. Five off the over after 12, Warriors 54 for 2.
Oh,
What a shot. That is Warner Park in St. Kitts. Basseterre in the capital. Shivnarine Chanderpaul, also part of this Tallawahs side. Set up. He debuted as a teenager in 1994. 164 test matches, are legend out of Guyana, and he's in the Tallawahs camp. Mohammed Amir now continuing. Well, he's been fantastic today already, picked up two in the power play.
Yeah, I think it's a good move from Robin Powell to say, look, I want one of my strikers back. Bowled two overs. I wonder if he was going to bowl three, but he didn't. He got rid of Sterling. And then he got rid of Chanderpaul Hemraj, a little tickle through. So two there up front means he's got half as his complement left, another two overs. So here's a good little move from Rovman to get him back to hopefully take a wicket.
Spoken like a true bowler there, Danny.
Get a guy that swings and shapes it. And so the captain says, listen, I need something from you. You're one of my number one striker in terms of swing and pace up front. And that was causing real issues with the new ball. So the partnership now 50 from 61. So again, there's a bit of solidity to the innings. Given it was rocked at 2 for 5 when Hemraj nicked out and caught behind.
Oh, well, it might be a cotton ball here. He's underneath it. Oh, he's put it down. It was tough. It was high in the sky. And the sun's out, Danny.
Did the right thing. It was definitely Mohammed Amir's. He had to make ground after he delivered it because the other fielders, Green out there, a long way away. And I think Pretorius as well. Beautiful slower ball. Deceived Shea Hope. Got there. Did all the hard work. Yeah, running back over your shoulder, and as you say, Alex Jordan, very difficult. Also, there's that very soft bit of white cloud, quite a bit of white cloud, and you think it's a white ball coming down in it. Sometimes a little hard to gauge the distance and pace of it.
Yeah, a little hazy. Ah! Well, I guess everyone's in it to win it, aren't they, in terms of becoming the hero fan of the match.
I don't know about the guy, the pink head, a bit scary. Nightmare on Warner Street.
You don't want to go to Grenada for Carnival, Danny. If you're afraid of that.
Yeah. Look, us wee hobbits.
Jab, jab. The spice mask, they'd eat that up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a little mere morsel entree.
Tons of color and energy and enthusiasm in this part of the world. It is what makes watching cricket here at the CPL just so exciting. Oh, it's a big appeal. It's a big appeal. Will they go upstairs?
Keeper went slightly across Amir Django, but Mohammed Amir is adamant, wants it. And it's a biggie because it's the captain. Shimran hit my eye saying, yep, there you got to go and ask the captain. So going to come upstairs.
You're right. Well, Mohammed Amir is convinced that he's got his man here. We'll have to go through the process right now. Check the front foot, no ball, etc.
Also came a little bit across there, and that's Hetmeyer's trigger movement. He does go back and across slightly, and maybe he was just trying to get inside this line a little, whip it, and just check, because he's always a bit of a contender. That's okay. Quick bowler, any quick bowler loves to get close.
Fantastic shoes as well, worth mentioning.
Looking. Is it angling? Ooh, might be just missing. I reckon he's quite wide on the crease with this one. He comes in and he comes wider as Mohammed Amir, but he's a bit more wider on the return crease with this one. Trying to maybe spear in a Yorker, but he went full. Just going to check ultra edge. I think he's got plenty of daylight, so no wood involved. No bat until it hits the pad. But I think it's sliding, AJ.
Well, there'll be many Warriors fans wishing the same. Ball tracking now. Yeah, it's missing, but by quite a bit there. They'll lose the review.
Aha! Bowlers, eh? Never let them feel.
He couldn't have been more sure, Amir.
That's the problem. So you got a keeper, particularly in this form of the game. Keeper is your captain, or a guy that can stand at first slip who doesn't have to go in a hot zone. You see, you need them up to be close and down the line a bit. So your keeper has a lot to do with it, whether he's captain or not. It's so important with the keeper looking where the bowler's coming from, the line and everything. So he went a little wider on the crease here, actually. So look at spearing it in. Bowler gets so excited. He thinks he's got his Yorker right. But in the end, he's missed by some margin. Doesn't he know it? Mr. Powell.
Captain's wondering what they were on about. Another wide.
Well, just, yeah, just to elaborate a bit more on that, is that Robin Powell is now way down at long on. He's in one of the hot spots or long off. He tends to be on the fence at times. Yes, he can be up here now at mid-off, but he wasn't when Hetmyer got hit on the pads.
Last ball of the over. Collected by the captain. Seven off it. The Warriors are 61 for two. Shimron Hetmyer, 37 off 42, the captain battling on here alongside Shea Hope for the Warriors. It's a hungry business, this cricket. Luckily for us, Creamery Novelties. They offer delicious treats for ice cream lovers. Simple to eat, even he can eat it.
This should be down there in immediate effect with an ice cream. The ice cream addict, Ian Bishop. I'm joining you, Bish.
Bish, is yours a cornetto or an ice cream sandwich? Cornetto, he says.
All of the above. Throw it all and get a tub of it too.
Right, welcome back everyone to Warner Park. 61 for two after 13, the Warriors. Miguel Pretorius now.
Swapping ends as well, and often the case you see in T20, particularly at this venue as well, that bowlers will have to move around and swap and be prepared to do that. Fabian Owen, cage tiger patrolling the boundary. But when you look at it here, is that the breeze, we keep going on about this substantial breeze here at the moment, and bowlers will have to be able to move and swap ends, able to be adverse to do that. Haven't seen this man bowl though, have we, Fabian Owen?
Sure, Fabian Allen wants the ice cream.
He's in the firing line there on the western bank. I'd like to see a bowl at some point. Must have a niggle.
Oh yeah, the ramp shot, clever. Clever, it might not get to the boundary, but some innovation from the Warriors on a difficult pitch.
Wow, that is right on target of the stumps. He misses this. He's got his poles knocked over, or if he gets his pad in the way. This is high. Yeah, look, it's gutsy. Because he knows Pretorius is about Yorkers as well. It's one of his go-to weapons. South African speed merchant. But geez, he did well there. A bit of a laugh about it too.
Beautiful, straight down the ground. Hero maximum, certainly. Shea Hope looking like he means business.
Well, the simplicity of it was superb. It was just a lovely, crisp strike and a little punch follow through just to there. That's all it needed. Those on the bank are loving it. And we we up here too, and I hope you are at home, because that is a clean, clean strike here from Shea Hope. His first maximum.
Oh, another big swing. Didn't quite get hold of that. It'll get a single. This is a treat for West Indians. These two batsmen on strike. Shea Hope, Shimron Hetmeyer.
Well, it's been a very, very solid partnership and much needed. 65 from 70. They've had to weather that storm early on with that new ball, with the power play, and those couple of overs past the power play, to then allow the Warriors to this mini platform, if you like, to see if they could get up to, well, at least past 140. Got to, I reckon.
Yeah, they'll need to. We just saw Fabian Allen. He's in the Jamaica side this year, as well as Brandon King, two Jamaicans returning home. Both big hitters. So the Warriors will be wary and aware about getting some runs on the board.
One of the umpires there, just maybe a little look here. Watch this, watch Hetmeyer. Does he run right up the middle of the pitch? Naughty, naughty, naughty. Just to the side, but he took a while to get off to the side. Here you go. Umpires hate this. Given the moisture levels in the pitch, look at that. Yeah, there's a couple of good strides on it, yeah.
Oh, this Fabian Allen there, safe hands. Was never going to miss that, was he? Republic Bank classic catch to get rid of Shea Hope.
That is why Fabian Allen is always out there patrolling in that hot zone. Mid-wicket, square leg on the fence, or a very straight mid-wicket, because he is just so good and he covers the ground so quickly. He made this look so simple, and it's not, I promise you, because Shea Hope got a lot of that. It was humming nicely through the air. Bowler's delighted, just been pumped for six, but got his man, Hope. Has to go for 25 from 30, and the Warriors are 71 for 3 now.
Burbis, Guyana at the crease, the both of them. Here's Romario Shepherd, the new batter, joining his country mate. They come from the same place in Guyana, Burbis. Big hitting guy, Romario Shepherd.
And strong, just about to say, this guy gives it some. And if he gets in and gets set, check out the strike rate, no surprise. And if he can last, the next three or four overs and gets plenty of the strike, then look out. So he's been sent up the order at five a little earlier, understandably so. Nicholson Gordon, good luck.
Yeah, he's gone for a few already. None for 24 off his two. Oh, it's up. That's actually simple. Simply taken. Wicket again for Nicholson Gordon. And fantastic Eldorado celebrations. He's feeling it.
Yeah, he's just asking the umps, is it over waist high here, is what Shimron Hetmeyer was saying. I just want to check it. I think it's marginal, but I think it's unfortunate for Hetmeyer with his connection, because it deserved to get scythed away over point. Could have even gone into the old scoreboard, boshing into there, six. But I'm just going to check this upstairs. Nigel Duguid is our TMO. Just checking the height of the delivery. Go through there, the front foot, that's all good. But yeah, it's the other end. That's the concern. Hetmeyer thinks, well, was it? Please, umps, have a look. Pray so. Oh, it's tight. Tight, but I think it's legit. Yeah, it's tightest, but you know, your batters, come on, all your own way. Unfortunate for the Warriors, because they've now lost the two set batsmen. both out now. Hope and Hentmeyer, the double H's, are gone. Out of here. The fourth one goes down. It is 71 for four here. Up. Yep, confirmation. So, yeah, 71 for four with Hentmeyer out of here. He's got to step over the line. Out for 39.
Yeah, Heinrich Klaassen, Romario Shepherd, two fresh batters at the crease for the Warriors. Nicholson Gordon continuing his spell. We heard Ian Bishop talking about this young man, Nicholson Gordon, earlier. He was in the West Indies under 19. And if you put it into context, Danny Morrison, that he then has his T20 debut at 30 years old, it tells us something about the man, the tenacity, the staying power.
100%. And late bloomer. And the other thing about injuries, if you can run in a ball quick, and, look, your action might not be textbook, but you can still have a unique action ball quickly and effectively. So, look, a few injuries, things change in your life. Quick, he's aggressive. And there's a lot of good stuff about that action. Strong. Shea Hope was the first to go, and then the full toss there. Hentmeyer thought it was a bit high, but just wanted to ask on his rights, but it was a legitimate delivery and they had to go. Yeah, some really good catches too. I keep going about this. Look at this.
Yeah, it was humming. So a rebuilding job necessary here for the Warriors. They did pretty well considering the power play was 15 for two. It was hard going up front. Always got that away. Four runs. He'll be happy with that, Romario Shepherd.
Well, that's the thing you've got to adjust, don't you? You've had the left-handed Hentmeyer, but now you've got the right-handers are in. And you've got to get off those pads. You simply can't bowl there. It's any form of cricket, even the older under-15s. It's on-leg stuff, and it's just so inviting for Shepherd just to help it on its way. Nice little boundary. Nice and early in his innings.
It lands safely. The wicket of Shimron Hetmeyer and 9 runs in that over. The Warriors 80 for 4.
Definitely dominating bat in this first game here, match number 4. Guyana Amazon Warriors taking on the Tallawahs on a warm Saturday morning. Just 4 fours, a couple of sixes, outstanding figures for Chris Green. Miserly, none for 5 or 4. Imad Vasim will bowl the 16th. Gets the arm ball right, always brings the ball in to the right hand, as does Imad Vasim, hurrying Romario Shepherd on the occasion.
Down, I'm here.
It's been tough going, isn't it, Bish? For the batters, trying to get to grips with the conditions, bit of dampness, pin, and a bit of seam movement for the seamers.
Yes, it has been. That first power play that produces, Alex, Jordan said 15 runs for two wickets. Just soaked up some overs. It was always going to be difficult knowing when to press the accelerator, how much is a good score.
Down.
Because conditions, Murali Kartik, as you know, will evolve by the time the Tallawahs get to bat. But I'm going to see how Shepherd and company negate or negotiate these last 4.5 overs. Oh, hello. Thank you very much.
Change in field because Romario Shepherd has got a unique place to stand at the moment. Slip goes back to short third. Short cover drops back to the circle. Yep, that's why. Stays outside leg stump, and before the bowler bowls, it's a hero maximum as he walks in. Brilliant shot from Romario Shepherd.
And that young man will be clapping even more because of this shot. That would be hitting with the wind today because the wind has turned around because of the little tropical storm that we have in and around the region. That's Romario's little young man. Not sure, but he told me a story, Kartik. He says his young one doesn't really think much of him when he's bowling, but he considers daddy more of a batsman. So when daddy gets runs, he's happy. When daddy gets wickets, he's not too fussed.
Yeah, rhythm is in the air, rhythm is in the land, that's for sure, Bish.
A number of the players have their families here with them. Rian Griffith, the coach of the Warriors this year. Seen Shafin Rutherford here with his family as well, and great to see. Don't know if Romario's family's here, but nice to have the kids, the wives, the girlfriends in the environment. With all the travel involved.
Yeah, great striking there. Standing way outside the leg stump again.
Oh, is that?
Quicker and slightly shorter from Imad Wasim. Yeah, we saw quite a bit of turn for Chris Green. Imad Wasim is somebody who predominantly bowls more seam up. The thing is that both of them are new to the crease. 14 of 8 for him. It's 89 for 4 after 16. Yeah, 4 overs left. 1 over left apiece for Amir, Pretorius, Gordon, and Imad. How do you see it panning out, Bish?
Amir, you would expect to come in and bowl one of these. Wonder if Miguel Pretorius might be trusted. And I want to say I like the way that Powell has gone around his captaincy. I've said it before. Imad still has one. Might be Amir and Pretorius for those final couple. Nice one under the bat.
change of pace. Well disguised too, because he runs in so hard. Sometimes it, with that kind of an action, he'd be a great asset if he can master that slower one. Different action. It's like a bit of a curve ball, which didn't curve, but definitely dropped on Heinrich Klaassen. Strike. Miguel Pretorius watches it sail over his head. A hero maximum for Heinrich Klaassen.
I was busy watching Nicholson's Gordon's reaction as the ball was traveling out there as well. Hoping against hope it would drop into the hands of Chris Green. There he is again. Preempting the landing of a shot, and then he realizes Green can't get there.
Yeah, I think his celebration was possibly because of what the wind conditions have been at this venue for quite a while. Every time he's played, yeah, he was already celebrating because he thought that it was that same against the breeze hit, but unfortunately for him, it was something different. Come on, Nicholson, you can't be making a mistake like this.
Just a reminder, because of the weather systems in and around the Eastern Caribbean, the direction of the wind has changed, and I referenced you when you said Amir had bowled from a different end this game than the first game. Almost blowing in the totally opposite direction. It usually comes right to left, but now it's kind of going from bottom left to top right because of that weather system hanging around.
Brilliant fielding off his own bowling. Overdone, 8 off it, 97 for 4. Yeah, it's always better to go straight and downtown against him if he's bowling it short. Imad Wasim brought his leg back and trying to go across it. Heinrich Klaassen.
Of course, we have a great initiative in the Hero CPL with the Lasco emerging player. Each team has 2 in their squad, and each of them has to play, well, certainly they have to play 5 games between themselves. And that's a great shot. It really is a demanding shot that requires extreme power off the back foot.
100 up with that hero maximum. And also, as you said, apart from the power, it was skill too. On the back foot, rather than a pull, it was over long gone. He's powered it over long gone. Again, quick into the surface from Imad Wasim.
And 43 all to Imran Tahir, but we were talking about the young players. None of them on the field or involved in this game, but 5 games have to go to a peer or one of those Lasco players, and at the end of a season, the best gets an award. At Jaden Carmichael, your guy. Ramon Simmons, who was brilliant the other night. Akeem Ogiest in the squad here. So many young talents. Matthew Nandu.
Oh, he's clubbed it over long off again. Romario Shepherd and his power on show.
Imad Wasim, I think there was a couple of balls ago, he tried to bowl the finger spinner, but it was quick and into the surface. Maybe he just would have meant requiring varying the pace a touch.
Outside edge. And the Amazon Warriors will take them whichever way they come. Expensive over. The most expensive in this match so far. 17 of it. It's 1-1, 4-4. This partnership is blossoming nicely. 43 of 23. The last five overs have gone for 53. There may be a couple more good overs, two big hitters. Miguel Pretorius will bowl the 19th. You reckon 140, something which they'll be happy with, Bishop, given the start, given the conditions, and hoping, they'll be hoping, all their spinners will be hoping that that dampness continues for a bit more.
After being 15 for 2 at the end of the power play, where the ball was sticking in the pitch quite a lot, if they get to 140, it'll be something they can work with, given the options they have. Yeah, good call by the umpire, with Imran Tahir and Tabrez Shamsi and Gudakesh Moti. Even if the pitch dries out a bit, they'll be hoping there's something to work with for them. So a different challenge was posed in the power play compared to some of the other games we've seen in this tournament.
Oh, nice. A bit of a helicopter on the offside. Gets it over and gets it for 4.
It's good striking from Romario Shepherd. And here in the Caribbean, we've known about his hard-hitting prowess. And even though that was inadvertent, he didn't mean it to go that fine. Maybe he was looking for it to go squarer. I like the fact that, and I'd advise him not to put away the offside shot. When it comes there, we know he's strong there, but he can hit the ball over extra cover and over point, and I'd like to see him do it more often as the 50 partnership comes up.
And another helicopter all along the ground, though. Didn't take off that helicopter, but wonderful. Wonderful from the time Romario Shepherd and Heinrich Klassen came together. In fact, on 71, this partnership has prospered.
It is an interesting field with the 3 deep leg sides and 2 deep on the offside. So Pretorius is keeping 2 options open to go for that ball into the pitch to hit leg side, and also looking for that wide yorker or wide pace off.
Both these batsmen also have an open chested sort of a stance. Cleaned him up. He spoke about the options. It was either the wide yorker or into the hole. Into the hole, and knocks the stumps off. And it's Romario Shepherd who's been dismissed.
Top class bowling, because look at the stance of Shepherd. He is keeping his options open for wide yorker or for the one that comes straight. But this one is straight and effective. Under the bat. And that's where any seam bowler, even slow bowlers, if you can get as many of those in an over at the death, it's gold. Pretorius strikes. Shepherd played well for 36, 122 for 5.
Yeah, but it comes back with a bit of a vengeance there. Miguel Pretorius, but hit for a four. A nice delivery to get rid of Romario Shepherd. Odin Smith. Straight hit, straight strike, and can't get there. Just over the boundary. In my opinion, it's a six of the very first ball.
Yeah, it's gone for six. But it's just an indication of the tremendous power, first what we've seen from Shepherd, and now what we're seeing from Odin Smith. And that's why so many regional cricket fans are excited about that sort of prowess of power hitting as it matures. Reflection on that Shepherd wicket. He heard the noise, and with the bat swing, he looks back, much to his chagrin.
Mohammad Ame will bowl the last over. Oh no, that's a tough call. Bish, that's a very tough call. A harsh call.
The umpire is a former left-arm seamer himself. I would say, yes, I'd agree with you, because it's at the point where it passes the umpire, but look, he's seeing it in real time. Dighton Butler, how are you?
Yeah, overcorrecting there. And got a bit of bat to it. Nobody to protect that. Four off the first ball after the wide.
Mistake with the short fine leg in play. He's got three men, including Kenar Lewis and Fabian Allen, on that leg side boundary.
Oh, what a shot. Yeah, that is the danger if you've got mid off up there and you bowl a delivery which is slightly outside the off stump. Heinrich Klaassen can access that area. What a shot.
And more importantly, they're getting within striking distance of that 140 you talked about. And with that spin bowling or balanced attack with your rounders Shepherd and Odin Smith, this is something I don't know whether it's a winning score, but it's something that the Amazon Warriors can certainly work with.
Also, given, as you said, when they were 15 for two after six, what they would have looked at, hoped for, I'm pretty sure they would be hoping close to 150. Shorter, slower bouncer there from Mohammad Amir. Heinrich Klaassen didn't know how to play that shot.
Yeah, you think about going after it and then you have to reset, and by the time you've reset as a batsman, it's gone. It's such a phenomenal delivery to have in your armory.
There was a time when many of the spinners were trying to bowl the double bouncer so that it just stays low and the batter can't access it, hits the base, and then they changed the rule that you can't bowl that. Another slower one. Odin Smith wants a run. Mohammad Amir with this hit. And misses it from close quarters.
And they have to keep your eye for that happening again. If Odin Smith misses it, they may try, so the keeper has to be at his ready. Sometimes you'd see the keeper take one glove off just in case.
Yeah, boy! Is it caught behind? It's been given by Dayton Butler. So another wicket for Mohammad Amir. And it's five down for the Warriors as Odin Smith walks back.
He's mixed up the over, so Kirtley Ambrose likes it.
started with a wide, then one down the leg side, a couple of short, slower bouncers, and now going for that wide Yorker again. A lot of value in experience and the ability and skill to execute. 6 from 2 for Odin Smith, 1-3-8 for 6.
Just the last delivery left, and Kimo Paul will be on strike against Mohammad Amir. Very fine shot, third, and a shot fine. Oh, what a shot. What a brilliant shot to finish. Just one ball is all he had strike for, and to play a shot like that, finishes it in style. 14 runs of the over. And the Warriors managed to reach 142 for the loss of 6 wickets.
These are the little things that you want to see happen in T20 cricket. It's just one ball, but it's a strike rate of 400. You had Odin Smith, who faced 2 balls, hit a 6. Then you had Romario Shepherd coming in, 36 from 17. And who knows whether these little, very little cameos in this case can make a difference to the outcome. I don't know. Chris Green will be hoping that it doesn't. But the Warriors have something to work with, given that they were 15 for 2 after the first 6 overs of power play. This could be exciting.
Yeah, absolutely spot on, Vish, because the last 3 overs have gone for 45. These are the mini phases or the mini things which teams practice nowadays, because a batter could only be there for these kind of deliveries. Brilliant from Romario Shepherd, 36 of 17, all the impetus to the innings. Shimron Hetmeyer played a lone hand for a while, 39 of 45. Heinrich Klaassen, 22 of 15, and then Odin Smith, 6 of 2. Kimo Paul, just that solitary delivery to face and hit a boundary. So 142 for 6 is what they've reached. Mohammad Amir, 3 for 22. Pretorius, 2 for 35. Gordon, 1 for 41. Expensive today. Imad Wasim, 2. But the pick of the bowlers and the most miserly of them, Chris Green, none for 5. And he's with Gautam Bimani.
Yes, thanks. Thanks, Karthik. Yes, normally if you call someone a miser, it's probably a rude thing to say. But in the context of a game like this, Chris Green would lap it up any time. The end belonged to the Warriors, but the start, 2, 4, 6 and 8 you bowled, 20 dot deliveries, even by your miserly standards. You would have liked that?
Yeah, look, I was very happy with the way the ball came out today. The conditions obviously suited what I do, and I just tried to vary it as much as possible. Obviously, I wanted to try and keep the stumps in play. We know here at St. Kitts you don't want to be too full because it's not so long straight, so it was great to be able to just fire it in there and try and get some spin and then try and sneak some through.
With a bit of moisture, we were all expecting it would be Amir and the quicker bowlers who'd do the job. Was there always a plan that you'd bowl 3 overs in the power play and then one more straight through, or was it just a rhythm?
Yeah, look, I think based on last year, I had a lot of success against Guyana in the 2 games that we had here, particularly up front to a lot of their left-hand and right-handed openers. And it's a challenge that I love bowling in the power play. So when Rodman threw me the ball, I lapped it up and it was great to bowl 4 straight.
15 only is all you conceded, but you finished the innings at 142. How do you assess that total, given the conditions here and given their bowling attack?
Yeah, look, I think you've got to give credit to Guyana and the way they stuck at it. It was a tough wicket to bat on early, but the main thing they were able to do is keep wickets in hand and have a dip at the end there with Shepherd and Klaassen. And so I think it's a good blueprint for us to go by in our run chase. I think you can't win the game early, you can definitely lose it. So if we can keep wickets in hand and look to use our hitters through the middle and at the back end, I think we're going to give ourselves a red crack.
Good luck for the run chase. I think we'll call it a green print, not a blueprint.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, nice words from Chris Green. He was so economical, none for 5. Roman Powell won the toss, and you can say a crucial toss on a sticky wicket. And it was not easy. Paul Sterling trying to go down the track to the Pakistani paceman, only holding out to mid-off. And then immediately afterwards, Chandrapal Hemraj nicking one to the wicketkeeper. But it was Chris Green who kept things tight. Shimron Hetma and Shea Hope trying to build something back. Some powerful shots from the Guyana skipper. Some wonderful ones on the offside too. This was the drop of Shea Hope of the bowling of Mohammad Amir. Should have had one more. And clean striking. And then the wicket, Bish.
Yeah, it was a tough beginning, as you pointed out. Because Shimron Hetmeyer fell not too long after that. And Gordon was into his stride. But Romario Shepherd came in and played a wonderful knock. 36 from 17. Flexed his muscle, showed his power. And of course, that sort of build with Heinrich Klaassen at the end of the innings was so valuable because they actually put on 50. Most welcome.
Yeah, this was the wicket of Romario Shepherd. Miguel Pretorius having his man. And then Udin Smith came in, struck a six. Heinrich Klaassen a four. And a big last over. Got the wicket of Udin Smith though. Mohammad Amir, but ended up giving 14 runs in that over. Kima Paul finishing it with a boundary. And asked to bat first. The Amazon Warriors have reached 142, and the Tallawahs to go 2-2 need 143 at 7.15 runs per over.
Every part, every deal, every wicket, every stroke. And the heart and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood.
It's how
when
we play.
Come out all nation, to the team in a unification. When the stadium ram beach at the grandstand, and the meaning of unification.
It's how we play.
play.
Welcome back to Warner Park here at St. Kitts. Match number four of Hero CPL. Tallawahs playing their second game this year, and Guyana Amazon Warriors their first, as they lock horns in the morning fixture here at Warner Park. Guyana Amazon Warriors asked to bat first. It was always labored. It was tough because there was a bit of overnight rain, bit of dampness on the surface. Couldn't get going. 15 for 2 at one stage. Hope 25 of 30, 39 of 45. That tells you a story before Romario Shepherd came and blitzed his way to 36 of 17. Klaassen giving him company, unbeaten on 22. Some wonderful bowling figures for a couple of bowlers. Mohammad Amir, 3 for 22. Chris Green, none for 5. 2 for 30, 35 for Pretorius, who's a hard-working customer, but expensive figures for Gordon today, 1 for 41. And Imad Wasim, given the conditions in the morning. Yeah, 3 for 22. I was joined by Bishop. I'm joined by King now. Stacey Ann King, your thoughts on Mohammad Amir?
I thought he used the conditions quite well. Know that he has a lot of change deliveries, so he bowls a lot of cross-seam balls. Picked up his 3 for 22. Again, good improvisation from him. Yeah, those three wicket balls came from different lengths. Let's look at those blue balls, different deliveries, but three wickets, three important wickets.
Yeah, but a lot of credit has to be given to this man for the Amazon Warriors reaching 142, Stacey.
Yeah, he knew he had to finish at the back end for his team. 36 off 17, three sixes and three fours.
Yeah, look at the Dream 11 Fantasy League scoreboard. Match number four, Mohammad Amir, courtesy those three wickets, 87. Imagine if Chris Green had gotten a few wickets. Miguel Pretorius, number two, Romario Shepherd, courtesy that innings at number three. It was quite bright in the morning, quite muggy, and suddenly we have a bit of overhead cloud cover. What's the meteorologist in you saying?
Once there's cloud cover, rain normally follows, but ground staff haven't started moving yet, so we're good to go. And they're enjoying it as well, so looking forward to this chase.
Yeah, big opening stand between Kenar Lewis and Brandon King in that previous game against the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. 183, if I remember correctly, the score was dead set, but a different surface today. And again, lots of bowling options for the Amazon Warriors. They've got the pacer, Odin Smith, Romario Shepherd, and Kimo Paul will bowl seam up. And two world-class spinners in Tabrez Shamsi and Imran Tahir, who hail from South Africa. Their very own Gudakesh Moti, a classical left-arm spinner. And also, if they need more spin options, they've got Chandapal Hemraj and some off-spin from Paul Sterling.
And yeah, they're quite known than Amazon Warriors for their spin attack. But as you mentioned, there's still Romario Shepherd and Odin Smith. Oh, I forgot Kimo Paul. Don't forget him.
It looks like they're going to start with the left-arm spin of Gudakesh Moti. Brandon King, good player of spin. Kenar Lewis, he can muscle you anywhere. That strike rate high, can always get higher. Brandon King does it nicely, does it neatly. Plays simple cricketing shots. Long off in place, a deep mid-wicket in place, a slip. Paul Sterling there.
Let's play.
And it'll be Brandon King on strike.
Ball.
A very old school, the way he bowls, Stacey, quite impressive. Very simple action, simple repeatable action. Tries to spin the ball. Gets a bit of drop on it too.
It's
impressive against India. And India toured recently. Unfortunately broke his finger trying to take a catch in the deep.
Well, it's good to see him here. Look at that thumb finger, that right hand thumb, heavily strapped.
Heavily taped, as you can see. Although it was his non-bowling arm, but if you fracture it, you're out of it.
He probably just has some protection on it, taping, and there'll be a bit of cushion under there.
This will be interesting. What do you think Kenneth Lewis is trying to do? Block or hit? Do you think he will try and take a single past the strike, or is it just one way?
Well, he did struggle in that innings that you mentioned for Jamaica Tallawahs.
Catch it.
Yeah, he started very fishy. Eventually, he got to 48 or 46, but by his standards, Kenneth Lewis, in 46 balls, you expect him to double that.
Oh!
Finds the gap. He was trying to block him from playing that shot, ended up giving that shot to him with the Keshmoti. First boundary for Kenneth Lewis.
Yeah, and that'll do his confidence very well. He attempted a slug sweep. Muti just trying to whip that one in.
Appeal, but a muted one. First over done, it's five without loss. First over of spin done, just that one boundary in trying to bowl the block hole or bowl it much fuller from Gudakesh Moti, but it'll be Romario Shepherd from the media end. ...142 on the board for the Warriors to defend the first game that they're playing in this season of the Hero CPL. Brandon King. And what about his innings? One king to another king.
Yeah, he was really exceptional in that game one. That is offside scoring options. He bossed it. Red balls, 89% red balls scored on the offside. Scored 89 off 57.
Called a wide by umpire Jayton Butler. Hey, you spoke about Kenneth Lewis. It was either a big shot or a nothing shot, either a block or a big shot. So it'll be interesting what they've spoken about, because sometimes if you're at the other end and you're only trying to go one way, it can also upset the rhythm of the batter at the other end. Also want him to take singles like these.
Yeah, he's done his homework. There's much more intent from Kenneth Lewis. Not all the time you can just power and hit down the line. Actually, that four that he got to come off the mark, it was a pull shot. Very rare we see someone of his stature sweeping and pulling.
It's hit. And also interested to see, Stacey, if a young captain like Shimron Hetmeyer will bring the spinners and his two trusted spinners very quickly, because whatever dampness will be on the surface will be there right now. As it dries out, it gets a lot more easier, isn't it? There's already been the heavy roller, which has gone over during the innings or midway through the innings. It'll be interesting how quickly he brings on Tabrez Shamsi or Imran Tahir, or in fact both, from both ends. Slapped over mid-off. Brandon King is underway.
Well, he might just be considering that option now. Can't afford to give away freebies here. Well played from Brandon King. Looked like he got all on it, but gets him a boundary still.
Hey, wasn't this the shot you highlighted when we played that snippet of his innings from the previous game? A couple of shots, so many shots through that area. Oh, finds the gap. Unintentional, but the result is the same.
Yeah, offside field scoring once again. That short third is in the ring.
Played through the offside. 12 runs off the over. The Tallawahs are 17 without loss. Without loss, and Danny Morrison always talks about our office. We are here at the Omega XL Match Center, Stacey, and it's a wonderful place to be.
And we've got the best seat in the house, best view.
Yeah, that's exactly what I wanted to see. How quickly does Imran Tahir come on to bowl? Can he extract something from the surface?
Oh,
extracts a bit of respect for sure.
Warriors fans, they just probably want to see him take that run. That lap of victory, that victory lap that he normally does.
Yeah, I've always been amazed by this bowler, having played against him, still going strong at 43, still has got the passion for the game, wants to bowl and get wickets. Plies his trade around the world, always wanting to learn even at 43. Bit of turn. Three different deliveries from Imran Tahir.
Yeah, I just love his spirit. He's always ready. He's always eager.
Ball near me.
Won't mind a single.
It's just one run of the over, and also you need to attack with him. Yeah, that's the kind of feeling you want to give to the batter, isn't it? There's a champion spinner up against you, trying to get you out.
Thank you.
Yeah, nicely turned away. Three singles in that over from Imran Tahir. It's 20 without loss. At the end of three, it's the 10th edition of the Hero CPL. And since we are here talking about Imran Tahir, who's got fond memories of this ground, a Hero CPL classic. 4 years ago, 4 for 22. Getting rid of Brandon King, who is up against right now. Devon Thomas. There you go, Stacey. 100 meter sprint.
Followed by that lovely punch.
Has anything changed? Yeah, 453 wickets under his belt. Fourth highest wicket taker in T20 cricket, Imran Tahir. But it's all about pace now. Odin Smith from the media end. Again, intentional this time. Again finds the gap between shot third and point. Another four for Brandon King.
And that's just too easy. Can't bowl that wide if you've got that third man up in the ring. Well played, just a roll of the wrist from Brandon King.
Yeah, 6 for 2 by the Warriors. It was tough going for them. Short delivery. And not in control, but it'll plug just for a single. Since we were on the topic of Imran Tahir, that's a beautiful word which you used. Spirit. Spirit is all you're looking for, and he's got oodles of it.
Sun is hot. Having a few drinks.
Does that go to third? It's taken. The field was changed after the boundary, and it's Kenna Lewis who is dismissed. It's a Republic Bank catch. A classic from Kimo Paul at third, and Odin Smith gets his fellow countryman.
Yeah, you saw the adjustment after that four from Brandon King. And Kimo Paul went around squarer. And Odin Smith gets his guy. Kenna Lewis goes for 6, 25 for 1, Tallawahs.
Wicket for the Amazon Warriors. Odin Smith getting Kenna Lewis, and that would have been the perfect idea at the halfway stage. Short boy. What a shot. Shamar Brooks. First in. Glorious back foot punch. Apologies. It's Brandon King.
Yeah, continuing where he left off, as I mentioned, just liking to score on that offside.
Yeah, this is what is so good from him, isn't it? He plays some clean shots, some wonderful shots. Shots which are written in the book. And he has immense power playing it too. So, again, as you said, he's continuing from where he left off.
Yeah, just think from Ghana Amazon Warriors' perspective, if you're going to keep that line You know, Dean Smith, that offside, the offside line, then don't need that backward square fielder. This was the catch of Kenna Lewis. Kimo Paul. It had looked so easy. Yeah, I think I'll just bring in that other fielder and put more protection on the off.
If we're gone, 30 for one. Big hitting Kenna Lewis back in the pavilion, 6 of 7. Shamar Brooks yet to face a delivery, and it's Brandon King, 23 of 17. Couple of overs left in the power play. Guthukesh Modi started with the new ball and he'll continue. Another over in the power play and bowls well.
Just 5 runs coming off his first over. 4 dot balls. A good choice. Since they haven't been able to score freely off him.
Yeah, the idea would have been to chip away with wickets, use the spinners. Somebody needs to have that attacking mindset. Stacey, you've got quality spinners also. With a mindset to get wickets. And it's very important when you're defending a sort of a lowish target. Slip in place for the new man, Shamar Brooks.
Catch it!
And we've only seen Guthukesh Modi and Imran Tahir, so there's still Tabriz Shamsi, Chandrapal Hemraj, where spin is concerned.
Yay!
The appeal is definitely strong. It's not been given yet. And Guyana Warriors have reviewed it.
Well, they look very confident. Guyana Amazon Warriors, they went up right away. Wicketkeeper Henrik Klassen.
Fine there. Nice strong action from Guthukesh Modi. Tossed up. Playing back to a delivery which was pitched. Extra bounce. Was it off the face? Both Heinrich Klassen and Paul Sterling went up in unison.
Yeah, they are in better positions to hear it actually. There you go. Comes off the glove. Of Shamar Brooks.
Yeah, the umpire, the Dane Smith, will have to reverse his decision, and the move to bring Guthukesh Modi pays off. Shamar Brooks goes for a duck. Tallawahs are 31 for 2. Skipper in. Skipper Roman Powell in at number 4. Again in this lineup of big hitters, he's one more. Skipper of the Jamaica Tallawahs.
quick starter against spin, is he?
Now this is the reason why he's here. Brooks trying to go back to guide that one pass in slip region, but enough glove.
Oh, lovely.
Again. Just one run. And a successful over for Gudakesh Moti. 5 gone, 31 for 2.
Brandon King on 24. It'll be a key passage of play because this man, Tabray Shamsie, has been outstanding in T20 cricket in particular around the globe. He was here with South Africa last year, for example, and he's played in Hero CPL before. Number 2 in the T20 rankings. And has played a lot of cricket here at Warner Park because he's played for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots for a few seasons up to 2018. And another reason Danny Morrison is, yes, Brandon King will be challenged, but Rodman Powell also has to still dispel maybe that reputation of being weak against wrist spin. So this is key.
A lot of West Indians over the years, Bish, haven't they? Just seem a little bit mechanical against it. Wristman, that is. And he is so difficult. So difficult. I think that's probably pitched outside. Maybe just. And spinning down the leg side. But, geez, they're up and pumped because two in the power play. Can they get three in the power play? And, of course, that big stat that we keep throwing out there. You lose three inside six overs and you really are under the pump. Sort of about 70% of the time you come second. But yeah, history of top order players playing against Risman. Oh, he's got away with this. I just hope he gets out his shoe. The celebration. Another one of those little El Dorado celebration. We maybe used to take his shoe off, get a wicket. Brilliant.
LBW appeal, perhaps spinning past leg stump. Powell is quick, King is quick, they get home safely. Pitched on, but spinning past leg stump, I would think. So good decision by the umpire. Dighton Butler played 5 ODIs for the West Indies and 1 T20. And that T20 was the inaugural one for the West Indies. Ended in a bowl-out in New Zealand in 2006. Now, this is another key here. We talked about Rodman Powell to the wrist spinner. Can he dominate or will Shamsie in the last over of power play?
It's always fascinating, particularly a captain when he is a top-order player in this format where you've got to get on with it and get things moving in a hurry. 2 to go on the power play. Slippers in at Sterling. Yeah, does he winkle a googly here? Very full. Too full for that stroke. Rovers. Little bottom edge onto the stumps, and that's what can happen. He's survived and got away with it. Just a misjudgment in the length. Very full. He's yorked himself with that.
I had a little thought and we'll come back to it after the power play's finished. Just a little option that Tallawahs could have used.
Oh,
and not sure. Powerless picking. Power play complete. 33 for 2.
Thank you. Oh my. I'll tell you what, whenever the Guyana Amazon Warriors are playing, their fans are about in their numbers. Roma, tell us what you were doing yesterday.
So yesterday, the rain was pouring in Nevis, but we are on home praying that the rain would stop falling so we can come to St. Kitts and watch the game, because we know we boys have this today.
Well, your prayers came through. Sun is high in the sky. What time did you take the boat over from Nevis?
So we took the boat at 8 o'clock this morning because we're excited to watch the match.
It was pouring rain at 8 o'clock this morning. These fans are ready. Y'all winning it this year?
Yeah! We're winning it this year! Yeah! We got it, we got it. The finals are playing in Guyana and we're so excited.
Have you come here, we enjoy it.
Oh! Imran Tahir. Yeah, I was wondering if as an option, and I'd love to see who's padded up, they might have gone to Amir Jangu, say, at the top of the order as a left-handed option, given that it would have been Moti or Imran Tahir, and then later on to Bray Shamsi, or whether they're looking for Jangu and... ...to bat through the middle with someone like an Imad Wasim, who is also a left-hander. Perhaps wondered whether they could use one of the opening batters as a left-handed option.
Oh. I'm hearing you, Bish. Just wonder, say, because he's quite 360, given the left-handedness, and also just those little paddle strokes. And when he gets in, he's not shy to use his feet, which is great too, Jungu. But I'm hearing you, and I'm just thinking they would have perhaps liked a little bit more out of that power play, wouldn't they? Sort of like get to 33-34. More of that was required. Hero maximum here from BK. A lovely strike from King. But a little bit of risk in it, but still got enough of it. And that'll feel good for King.
Has been striking the ball well. His innings in that first match was a thing of beauty. Working on his game against spin, and Imran Tahir's reaction was phenomenal. Slapped the ground. And he strikes back. Imran Tahir is off and running. There he goes. Someone stop him. To the Amazon Warriors fans in that southern stand near Lozak Road. Yes, his heart is in it. It's 43 and full of energy.
And it's 41 for 2. Given that he got pumped downtown. What a great comeback. What a great comeback. Makes it 41 for 2, means it's 41 for 3. And there we go. Gandalf, go get him. You magician, you. Oh, brilliant. It is the end of King, who got set but couldn't kick on. Got to 32, did King. And 41 for 3, the score.
Amir Jangu, who batted so well in the Sky X 60. A This is what we talked about, the spinners going to work. Not picking him. Not picking him. Not picking the googly. 41 for three. Seven gone. The evergreen Imran Tahir. That's a six, and I was interested in the reaction. The perfectionist in Imran Tahir slaps the ground, disgusted with himself, and now comes back and lands it. Landing gear down. Wicket taken, and he's on the runway, taking off.
It's wonderful to see, because Murray Carter was on about his age at 43. He's not too much younger than Carter's himself. Saying, geez, where do you find the energy to keep playing, the zest for it? But he is just so passionate and so keen and still loves the game. A lot of players will keep telling you, age is just a number.
Slip in place. Imran Tahir, as we know, bowls so many googlies, but he's able to mix it up occasionally and get that leg spinner working. And just holds off the surface as King was airing towards that long on, mid on. Ageless performer.
Underlined more what you were touching base about. Powell up against Rispin, another West Indian top order player, and King again missing out there.
Oh.
Set. He got into the 30s and it just had a bit more reach, and that's why Tahir was furious with himself, just a little over tossed. But he was brave enough to give that a little bit of air again and give it a little bit of Rispin to go out with a leg spinner away from the outside edge. So it was really a wonderful bit of cat and mouse and a bit of strategy, and he was good enough to deliver it to Tahir, of course. And now you've got your mate at the other end in Shamsi with left arm wrist. So these guys could be such a handful this season. And here are CPL 10.
For Django, I think that was the attempted googly. Still not convinced, as much as I perhaps, it's not a criticism of the option of using the left-hander at the top, but I'm not convinced Django is picking either. It's reading it off the pitch.
What did you say, Ian Bishop? He's got away with this, Django, in a way that, in another occasion, could have been a leading edge. Well, Brad Hogg, the West Australian, was such a good exponent of this. Left arm wrist spin. Shows you how tough it is on the frame. But yeah, very difficult to pick left arm wrist spinners. Hogg was another good exponent of that. Another one I used to bowl part-time was Simon Katic. And Katic used to as well, and I think Aussie fans felt they should have got a bit more out of him, being able to bowl left arm wrist spin.
We had one in the Caribbean here a few years ago, Dave Mohammed, who played for the West Indies. Another shoe phone man at one point. 45 for three. Imagine at a similar stage of the Amazon Warriors innings, they were 19 for 2. They ended up getting 142. Gudakesh Moti.
Get on it, get on it, get.
in more dots. After our stato, in terms of dots, dot balls, what are we up to? Yeah, there, Tallawahs, 27 of them. Warriors gobbled up 53 dots. And so far, look, we've already had eight overs, 8-point turnover, 27. Again, it just shows you the tricky nature of all the weather that's been around, the weather system here, particularly from Thursday night, early hours of Friday morning, all through Friday into today. And it's just made it much more tough going. The bowlers are having a little bit more of a say here. Fascinating.
2 for 9, 2 off 9 for Powell. 2 off 10 for Ruffman Powell. Strike rate versus spin in the CPL of 108 versus pace 143. But he has talked about his perceived improvement against wrist spin earlier this year. Scored a wonderful 100 against England, Adil Rashid and company in Barbados, went to India, had a couple of really nice partnerships with Puran, but we still see those little signs every so often against spin.
Well, 3 dots in this over, a couple of singles, and then, well, probably best to throw in the mix, you know, your captain, a lot of responsibility. Rodman Powell, they haven't won the Hero CPL since 2016. Those out of Jamaica. He's captain as well. Look at that. We've had 4 dots in that over, just 2 from it. It's 48 for 3.
And of course, Amir Jangu, when he played in the Sky X60 earlier on this very ground, had a wonderful half century. 68 from 27 against the Barbados Royals. It was an impressive innings, and it sort of catapulted him into the limelight to a wider audience. Of course, he's been around the regional scene for a while, in his mid-20s. Any sort of repeat of that nature would be welcomed by Tallawah. There we had the introduction of the inaugural Sky X60 leading up to this Hero CPL, and I think it'll just grow in stature.
Basketball, you know you love the NBA, that basketball music, you got the music getting faster and it just speeds up as the pressure comes on, fans get involved, clocks, shot clocks ticking down. Yeah, what I adored about the 60 Bish was that innovation, and really very important, was that you could only lose 6 wickets and you're gone. Couldn't have the full complement of 10 as in other T10 formats around the globe. So you lose your 6th one, you're out of here, done, dusted. We're only dealing in singles at the moment, just picking off the spinners here, and all of a sudden that asking race just going to bosh onto 9 now. Yes, it's 94 from 63. All seems very comfortable. But they have lost 3. And then if you suddenly lost 2 again in 1 over, they were to lose the skipper and someone, Fabian Allen, who's key as well. And you'd imagine he'd be close to be coming in next.
Sometimes at 4, and discussion as to whether Ruffman Powell could slot in as a right-hander between those two, having done reasonably well at 4 in international cricket this year. So those discussions continue. Played at 4 to finish off the last T20 international at Sabina Park against New Zealand. So we'll see how that discussion and everything else develops.
Well, you and I have been such an advocate for Puran to be up near the top with it. At 3, well, then maybe things progress a bit. Would you open with it? Depending on the opposition, possibly, and the surface and conditions.
Halfway mark of the innings, 51 for three. And time for the Angostura chill break.
Hero CPL on the 10th edition. This is match number four, and the Amazon Warriors were asked to bat first. Tough conditions. We had a late start here. So almost an hour later, 142 for six was pretty good in the end. Considering they were really battling at the start, they were two down for five. And a half-century partnership between Hetmeyer and Hope was outstanding. Well, 51 for three now. 92 off 60. Time to go back in the vault for a Hero CPL Classic. Phillips, one of three overseas players to get centuries in the Hero CPL. I think he owns two of them. He can hit it miles. Playing for the Tallawahs in the Eliminator. Back in 2018, and tremendous innings. Glenn Phillips. For two after 10 overs was what was happening at the stage for the Warriors. Now the Tallawahs are 51 for three. Hero fan of the match, well, as I keep saying. Hessen, the Hessmeister, runs off with the cash and all the ice cream. Kokomalan, covered up. 500 US. Take the bike as well. Get on that Hero hunk. And cut loose. Ah, what a day. Crowd and Saturday afternoon here. Just gone 1:30 local time. So this didn't get underway till 10:55. So a little bit stretched into the afternoon. Spinners though on both sides, short run-ups. Let's see if we can hustle through a few more. Looks like we're gonna have Odin Smith swapping ends. And the Losac Road end, city end of Warner. Django, they need him unchained here. Oh no, no. Some wood on it, brother. Hello, Stacey Ann King.
Hello, Danny. How are you?
All the better to be here with you and vibed and pumped. Just see if we show Django getting the 68. Yeah, Jangu is nice little innings. Can he reproduce? That was the 60. This is, of course, his T20. But, yeah, let's see if he can get going.
Yeah, I think they much more prefer the pacers. Things have been pretty quiet. Rugman Powell just 5 off 16. So, I'm just wondering if he's just trying to stick around, just have the spinners bowl out.
Now the Dream 11 fantasy scoreboard for this match. Still got a bit of time to go, but Muhammad Amir at the top there. Notorious wicket takers. You've got a little bit of Hetmyer with his innings and Brandon King as well. As all-rounders can have a bit of a say. But you get someone who goes all the way through, someone like Rodman Powell, to be not out at the end and win the game for the Jamaica Tallawahs, then likely to leap up the board there. Here's the other captain, Kevin Hetmyer, just sorting things out in the field. He's hot zone of the covers. Andrew Klaassen just moving some of the deep fielders as well on that leg side. Rightio, all in readiness with Odin. He's going to have to reload this one. Got a little excited at the bowl. He was doing a bit of a jig, wasn't he?
I guess he thought it was a glove, but it's far down the leg. Yeah, nothing from Rodman Powell there.
Yeah, which way to the dance floor? Movement, the skipper. Wow, he's 6 from 17. Isn't he striking at 35? But he just settling in. Can't make a complete call here for me, because all of a sudden, then you just get into your groove and cut loose and send the ball to all parts of Warner. It's tricky. Good effort. Masquerade, brothers and sisters. Stuff. Oh, Peach. That's what he can do here, Odin Smith. He just had that ability. All of a sudden, pull out a cracking delivery and you've lost your pole or got a little glove through to the keeper.
Yeah, good delivery to left-handed Jangu. Going off of singles now. Last couple overs as well. Just wonder when will they start going just up in the ante a bit, because spin has kept them tied up, especially Rodman Powell. You mentioned that 6 off 17 strike rate of just 35.
Suddenly, the asking rate is just creeping up towards 10. Starts to get over double figures, and then fielding side will try and create even more pressure. Oh dear, you don't get into the hip there of Rodman Powell, because this is all gone into the pool. Can someone get our ball back? I'll go myself, in fact, to get in there again.
Yeah, I think it just missed the pool. But Rodman Powell getting in at the end of 11, 61 for 3.
D-shaped pool for Daniel and the diamonds to get in the pool. This is lovely. In terms of if you're a Jamaica Tallawahs fan, it is just the ball you'd want to serve up for Rodman Powell with a bit of pace on it. And it's disappeared. It's in fact gone over the pool. Thought it went into those ferns and then got a little bit wet. Would have to have a new one. But no, they're sussing a new baller. It's gone out of the ballpark, bounced and gone over the fence. So new balls, please. And I think we're going to have a bit of Imran Tahir here. He's going to swap ends as well, as so often the case with bowlers. T20. Or six and then move, and you can swap ends on numerous occasions in this fabulous format. So he's going to run away from us, from our media centre end.
Yeah, just a lovely pickup. Dispatched. Connection from Rahman Powell.
Calypso swivel with one leg in the air. So Greenwich and Haynes. Yesteryear. It's a wonderful heady 1980s. So real job here to do now, given that we're into the second half of the 20 overs for Jamaica. Serves up a freebie. All it is a little rotation at the moment. An asking rate. Whilst it was getting close to 10, just shows you, isn't it? Stacey and King. 1-6 has changed things.
Yeah, but that was against pace. Spinners back now. Tahir into his third. He's only going for 12 runs. 7 dot balls. And he has challenged Rahman Powell. So they won't mind singles. Yeah, another 81 needed from 52.
Hitmeyer just calling some shots, and because he's out the fence, need to change and tweak the field. It was a little lovely bit of curve in the air there, given the change of ends for Tahir, in a different way of the breeze blowing. The breeze is actually blowing from the low-sec road and in from the ocean that way. Normally the prevailing wind comes over the top of the swimming pool there from the northeast. And so when you look at it like that, it is quite a turnaround in terms of the breeze, direction of it. The only man inside the circle on the onside, the Jangu's found him. Got to be able to rotate it. Tick it over. So many dot balls now. 36 dot balls so far for Tallawahs in 11.4. Teams arriving. The women. Big game. Royals Warriors. Whoever wins that goes through to the final tomorrow of the Massey CPL. TKR in the final of the three franchises. Women's game. In the air and all the way. Serves up another freebie, so unlike Tahir. We've had a dozen overs and the Tallawahs are 69 for 3.
Now you can see his disappointment, Imran Tahir.
Suddenly, spinners call back. Another no-brainer scenario. You get spin on both ends. Multi. You do it. Yeah, and all of a sudden, they just tick. A little single, that's all. A dot ball single. When, as you said, Stacey, going to unleash?
Ghana, Amazon Warriors, and Barbados Royals. Women. They play next, so they're here to go through their paces. Mind that the winner of that game will go through to the finals tomorrow. TKR already sits there.
It's crossed with the weather gods late this afternoon.
It's very full.
That's got to be, got to review this. It looked like it was very full. Klaassen liked it. He's about to signal leg buyers. Yep, they've come upstairs to give more work to Nigel Duguid, just to go through the process here. The front foot and then a little bit of bat involved or not, and then ball tracking. But if this is very full, which naked eye look very full and could look very out. Here we go.
And Moti again just trying to bowl a Yorker length, wicket to wicket. Really done well with their spinners. They've kept things tight. They haven't really given away too many. Guyana Amazon Warriors. They're all good. Jangu made a bit of movement. He moved across to the off. So that leg stump. Yeah, it's unprotected. Yeah, no bat involved. Straight into the pad.
I think the poles are going to be disappearing. The woodwork's going to get disturbed. Here we are. Ball tracking. Yep. Light them all up, buddy. Yeah, Klaassen, but particularly Gurgesh Moti, very, very adamant. And it took a little while to go upstairs. They did. And Verdane Smithers, you got to give that. Yeah, there's the plumber. He's getting in there. Got him. Django goes for 15 from 20. And the Tallawahs lose their fourth at 70. Wasim, Pakistani all-rounder. It's a spinning of his strongest suit, but he is very capable. You might argue the point of that. So I'm a genuine all-rounder. Rat bags upstairs, but can hit a long ball. He's got some lovely strokes in that locker of his. Another left-hander to swap over. Jangu bodes well. Let's just keep doing that, and then you think, well, where was Fabian Allen?
No.
Very nonchalantly, just wanting to survive the first, but yeah, in the end, we got our man, Kingy.
I'm not sure about we, but.
Who was saying it was out too?
Yeah, but it was good bowling from Moti.
Sure was. And as you mentioned, Stacey, he wanted to go full. He's going nice full of length, and he's very adept at getting it up there, and very good at it in terms of flighting it, looking for Yorkers and shutting down the batter to try and whistle him out of the ballpark. So there's that extra wicket we talked about.
Oh.
So more onus on the skipper, Rodman Powell. We've had 13 and it's 71 for 4. Two from 42 is what Jamaica want. But here. Another dot. Eating them up. Jamaica. 53 of them in the Warriors innings too, just quietly. Once again, the tension mounts. Yeah, there's some of that cheek. I was on about with Muhammad, with Ahmad Wasim rather. Angostura. Chill moment. Chill fan. Petronella. You just fan. Chill there under the brolly. Quiet little 200 US. Yeah, good stuff. Marcus Chilling. Gorgeous. Here's the captain on strike. Still can't get it out of gear one against the spinners.
Yeah, he's really struggling. But again, good bowling, good areas. The spinners have attacked. Yeah, good single. They still need another 70 or 38.
Yeah, about to do battle soon. Just the thing about Moti, yeah, was it 2 for 10? It was 17 dots in his four. So, Wasim will be thinking that we need to get a wriggle on here, skipper, because the asking rate now has gone up to 11.2 suddenly. It was near 10s and it dropped back to about 9.2 because of Robin Powell picking off Odin Smith. But suddenly it's getting a little bit of a tall order. They can't wait.
Oh! Yeah, just supporting their meal franchise team. At the end of 14, 74 for 4.
Yeah, youngsters are loving it. They're in the house here at Warner. And Griffith's son, the coach, he's got the flag and having a bit of fun. Stuff. So we're going to have pace back. This is interesting. Romario Shepherd. Certainly Powell will be pleased that the pace is back. But Ahmad Wasim's only just got out there. He's 3 from 5. And Hitmeyer feels this is the time. Let's knock over Ahmad Wasim. Romario, it's your job. Protection downtown brings the Jamaican captain on strike. And this will be what Rodman will be wanting. He'll be wanting to try and up the ante and get things shifting.
Yeah, he has a much better strike rate, Rodman Powell, against pace. He's struggled against these spinners.
Just settling in here. I keep saying that for Rodman Powell, but the asking rate has now gone to 2 a ball. Now, when it gets to 2 a ball, it's a little more interesting for the side chasing, given they're 4 down, but they have got their skipper there. Rodman is set, and he's been out there for 26 balls. He wants, and he's hustling. Oh, that's hurt. Yeah, that's hurt. It really is. That might have got him just on the shin, is it, or the inside of the calf? Ouch.
Yeah, and Odin Smith is the fielder. That had to be a powerful throw.
Yeah, nice. The Amazon Warriors are concerned as well. Hit it sweetly, wanted the single, and sprinting up the pitch. It's a powerful throw, and immediately rolls over and goes down. Let's have a look. Bang. Side of the leg there. I've seen a few of those Brazilian footballers do this. Won a penalty. Gee, the penalty is. He is very sore here, Rodman Powell. Really sore. He's taken the pad off and he really is still wincing. Might have got him on the shin there. He missed that inside and it's. Looks like it's come up rather uncomfortably. Yeah, it's going to be sore. So get the ice onto that, please, physio.
That's gonna hurt. That is more bone. That's a very bony area as well. So the magic spray is out. But it's already swollen.
Yeah, that's not looking too clever at all for Rodman Fowler. It was coming up, wasn't it? That lump was coming up. BetX fastest ball. Let's have a few of those. I'll tell you what, there's a few of them being thrown in by Odin Smith. He owns the fastest ball as well. 144, and a bit of Muhammad Amir, Mario Shepherd, Miguel Pretorius, Nicholson Gordon. I think Nicholson Gordon, surely, faster than that. 130, come on. BetX fastest, we'll have to crank that up. Yeah, but very uncomfortable scenes here for Robert Powell, hit from a throw from Odin Smith. Oh, it gets the full so far for the Jamaica Tallawahs. And it was up and over Kenar Lewis. And, got enough on it, but smart catching. Yeah! And a little glove was nice.
Yeah, Shamar Brooks. Courtesy Muti. Tamir. And then this was Jangu. Muti again.
Beautiful play. Gurukesh Muti. So lines have been good. Certainly that one from King getting out, caught by Blackwood. Sub off to here was key, really was. It just been hit for six and then got out. Straight away for 32. Skipper, he's been there a while. He's 16 off 27, but I wonder if he's going to stay on. He's trying to. There's a lot of cold ice spray on him. Magic spray that's extremely cold when it goes on. Full hobble on. So, yeah, 2 for 10 with 17 outstanding. So, 76 for 4 plays, 142 for 6 at the moment. We've got 33 deliveries left in the innings, 67 required. Moore Shepherd. And he's cuffed it. And he's got away with this one, as Ahmad Wasim. Lucky he didn't get anything on it.
Yeah, having a look at his bat, but lucky that it dropped short of Shea Hope.
Had new balls, how about a new bat? Mark, get a new bat, son. Not working. Stop it. Shepherd. Skipper, he'll just hobble through a little. So just get that blood pumping around where he got clocked on the low shin from Odin Smith.
Still shaking that leg. Still in a bit of discomfort.
And I think he will for some time, Stacey. But, really did come up big quickly. Right, Shepherd will finish out the 15th here, Mario Shepherd. Four singles only so far. Asking rate 12 and a halves. Hold on to the strike. So five off the 15th. And Jamaica are 79 for four here.
Haley Matthews, the Barbados Royals captain, Corey Cullimore, the former West Indies seamer, coach of the Barbados Royals, taking a view of the final five overs of proceedings. Sabre Shamsi back for his final over. How critical can this be? 64 required. goes after him and goes after him well for six for Imad Wasim.
Yeah, the perfect delivery to get a move on for Imad Wasim. Right in the slot, Tabrez Shamsi is an attacking bowler. He will present those opportunities. Flighting it, inviting. But the invitation went wrong. I would still say it's tantalizingly poised fish.
Big game coming up. The winner goes through to the final for the women. Goes again, goes hard. And Hetmeyer cannot stop it. The power of Imad Wasim. And since he's come to the crease, he looks to be picking the little bits of wrist spin that he's faced.
And actually, if you look at these two deliveries, they've been flighted and they've been hit-me deliveries. And now the bowler's under pressure. Because you've tried something the first ball, and secondly, you've tried something similar the second time up. And both times you've disappeared, so you're under pressure. You're trying to completely go away from what is your stock delivery.
At least a couple of runs. Gurakesh Moti doing the fielding.
It's the scenario, isn't it? It's the scenario, the situation you bowl according to. More than 12 and a half required as a spinner. You've got one over, you come in. Is it wickets you're looking for? You're looking for a tight over, which creates a bit more pressure. Put in already. Only three deliveries have been bowled.
Wasn't a bad option if he was bowling a touch wide of off stump with only two short fielders behind point. Should be taken comfortably. Shehoop wraps it in and the shoe is off and the shoe phone call is made. The end of Imad Wasim after a couple of lusty blows.
We've seen quite a few celebrations around the world. This is one of the most interesting ones. Yeah, nicely bowled. Not exactly what he wanted to do. He's just waiting for the catch to be taken before the shoe comes off. As long as he doesn't press it against his ear, Bish. Imad Wasim goes for 18. He's disgusted with himself. 93 for 5.
Success for Tabrez Shamsi after being struck for a six and a four.
This log sweep ball slightly short of where he wanted it to be and also spun. He was eyeing over midwicket and look at that. Look at that. Is that an acknowledgement or something, Bish?
No, he's calling Imran Tahir, who was at deep backward square. Imran took off his shoe and answered the call. And then they both put their shoes back on.
didn't pick it up on camera. It was brilliant to see. Ends the over with a wicket. That's what they wanted. 93 for 5. Required on the last four, so Tallawahs need a couple of decent overs, and the conversation continues between the two master wrist spinners, and now we assume it will be predominantly seam to close out. The spinners, the frontline spinners, are done. Odeen Smith, Fabian Allen on strike. The three deep fielders on that leg side. Deep point and third man. Three players central to this battle here all emanate from Jamaica. Rothman Powell, Fabian Allen, Odeen Smith. Four fielders now on that leg side field. Does he go hard into the pitch? Is he able to slot a Yorker in? No, he goes hard and goes outside off the outside edge for four. Third man came up. May not have stopped that anyway. Four important runs.
Swung hard. Really hard. Threw the kitchen sink at it. Rothman Powell. And there's no stopping that.
147 kilometers per hour. Shimron Hetmeyer goes to middle. So again, line has to be straighter. This straighter and into the pitch, and Kimo Paul will keep it to one.
Yeah, Imad Wasim wasn't happy with himself because he had hit this first ball for a six, which was right up there for a spinner. We call it a slot, not the seamer slot. But then the spinner trying to correct his length. There were a couple of deliveries in between which were wides, and also there was a reverse sweep attempted. But then just getting the right perfect delivery, which was thrown slightly wider, and it was turning away from the left-hander.
9 off the over, 102 for 5. In fact, we'll have to revisit that. There's a no ball called. Might be for height. The second over the shoulder. So it'll be a free hit for Fabian Allen. Intriguing to see as well whether Powell has gotten this right. It's just halted play to signal the free hit. I think the umpire forgot to signal free hit and aborted Odin Smith's run up to signal it. Four for Mario Shepherd. I'm going to come to Rodman Powell's innings because I think he has been trying to set himself up for that launch at the back, having tried to secure himself against the spin. Time will tell whether he's timed it correctly. They need 39 from these three overs. Well taken. Very well taken by Sheho. He was coming in and then had to self-correct and hold and just maybe take a half a step back.
Yeah, he misjudged it for a brief moment and then had to correct himself because he was running and charging in quickly. And you can see that celebration. The skipper is jubilant. Fabian Allen goes for 3. Tallawahs are 104 for 6.
Chris Green replaces Fabian Allen.
Yep.
Notched away, Odin Smith. Should have been Odin Smith. If it was a little bit slippery underfoot down there, boundary anyway.
Yeah, that's the last thing you want. And such a crucial juncture of the game. He comes taking it too easily or too casually. He slipped afterwards. There's a complete mess of it over there. And then adding insult to injury. Should have been one. Now it's 8 of 2, and it's Chris Green who's been the beneficiary.
Just checking whether it's 4 or 6. Luck to the TV umpire there. Critical call to get this right. My guess is as good as mine. Six signaled. 10 off 2 deliveries. Missed his yorker, paid the penalty. Hetmeyer will cut that off and keep it to 1. Now Ruffman Powell, 23 of 32, over to you.
You look for small moments in games like these. How costly is that going to prove, or will it? The misfield from Odin Smith.
That is massive. And that is Ruffman Powell at his very best.
Yeah, suddenly it's been whittled down to 22 of 13. 17 runs coming in this over. Oh, Romario missed his length. Went for 6 on the offside this time. Slightly short, but the power of Ruffman Powell powers it over extra cover.
Another 6, even bigger from Ruffman Powell. He's been waiting for this and timing this. 1-2-7 for 6, 16 to get off 2.
Yeah, what a big over, 23 coming. Once again missing his length, Romario Shepherd. I think this has landed straight onto the football field. New balls, please. Skipper just waiting for the right moment to launch an attack, and he's found the moment, found the over.
Yeah, the hero maximum's race. Brandon King with 7, Powell with 6, Kenar with 6. 3 Tallawahs at the top. Muscular team. He saw himself through the spin without losing his wicket. Was slow, but now he's given himself and his team a chance with 2 lusty blows.
Yeah, from both sides, it's interesting that certain bowlers have not been used, Bish. Fabian Allen didn't bowl for Jamaica Tallawahs. Kemo Paul hasn't bowled for Amazon Warriors. Yeah.
Kimo Paul played in the Sky X60 and Dinbol played largely as a batsman or sometimes was inactive. He's had his injury concerns and we don't know whether there's something still there. No Bersami Pamol or Paul Sterling with the ball for the Warriors today. Powell on strike. Jamaica versus Jamaica again. No chance of two. Paul is quick.
Amazing how one over changes the scheme of things in T20 cricket. With the ball, with the bat, he was going so strong, nearly 13 runs or 13 and a half runs required every over, and that to 6 wickets down, and suddenly one big over changes everything. Slower bouncer through with the shot. The interesting thing is, even if he bowls 3 more dot balls and you've got 14 runs left in the last over, who will bowl the last over? Romario Shepherd?
It will land safely. If this guy fielding the ball is fit, we don't know. Drizzle appearing here at Warner Park. Wrong staff have been on their marks. Right now, they're level on par with the DLS.
A bit of spice to the mix in the form of rain. If it comes hard, what happens? He said they're par at the moment. Just one more over to go. Still some sunshine. Clouds looming. Not too far from here.
How much can you give the person bowling the last over? Can you give them 10, 12 required to win? Can you close out this over with nothing more than two? Almost, but that is four. It was a top effort from Kimo Paul. 135 for six.
It was a superb effort because it was traveling. It was not a big shot, but it just kept traveling. And look at that leap. Couldn't do anything better than that. Kimo Paul. Maybe he could have been slightly behind, but it's a tough one. Will be signaled a boundary.
Outstanding from Kimo Paul. Saved a couple of runs. Ended up giving away the boundary. Hard for him to, even if he'd held on, to balance himself. More importantly, 8 required. And it will be Romario Shepherd to try to close out the innings. Can't understate Chris Green's hand here as well. 17 from 7. Earlier about Chris Green and his ability to impact the game in 3 phases in the field with the ball. Went for 5 runs off his 4 overs today. And now 17 from 7. round the wicket. Will he try to go full and wide of off stump? Wide signaled. That'll go for six. Ruvman Powell has muscled a slog sweep for a hero maximum, scores a level. A remarkable innings, given that he was way less than a runner ball for the majority of his knock.
Now, that's what you call the height of audacity. Just look at that. From outside the off stump, literally treat him like a spinner. Outstanding. And just preempting it to perfection.
He has timed this innings. He saw the spinners off. He took no risks against them whatsoever. And he was waiting for this last phase and the seamers, the young seamers, to come back. Well, not young, not young. And he's made them pay.
I know, I like what you do. You're always comparing every spinner, every seamer to yourself in terms of age, Bish. Definitely younger.
And Ruvman Powell and Chris Green do it. Take a bow, Ruvman Powell. This has been an outstanding culmination to the end of the innings, this partnership. 39 from 14. For the Tallawahs to win by four wickets.
Yeah, very nice innings, a very controlled innings. As Ian Bishop mentioned, never took any chance against the spinners who kept him on a leash. But then he knew that he could take off and launch his attack against the seamers. And that's why this innings has been timed to perfection. It's about calculation. When you're a batter, when you're a bowler, and Ruvman Powell has calculated everything, the profit and loss account to perfection.
Outstanding run chase in the end. Chris Green deserves a lot of credit for his all-round performance today. Good in the field, good with the ball, and important with the bat. Tough for Shimron Hetmyer and his men to be put into bat when the pitch was perhaps at its stickiest, but they made a fist of it. Plaudits to Powell, though.
Yeah, they'll rue a few chances, a few incidents in the innings, because they still had everything under control, the Amazon Warriors. But again, Ruvman Powell and Chris Green had other ideas.
Sir Kirtley really has led. There's a difference in Ruvman Powell that I've sensed in the last year and a half. King got 32. Kenar Lewis and Brooks didn't do as much as they wanted, but it was Powell's 44 from 38 where he timed his run chase. And Chris Green, Imad Wasim, struck a couple of crucial blows as well. We talked about those little cameos where teams and batters practice for those specific 3, 4, 5, 6 ball occasions at nets.
Yeah, the specificity of every situation which you could come up against is practiced nowadays, Bish. You hear the entire 20 innings being divided into lots of phases. Guthakesh Mothi.